And we checked our report numbers tonight. Bandwidth is crazy. When it's crazy, that means a good thing. Over 75,000 people tuned in right now. One moment. I'm loving that. I'm loving that.
I hear them talking cause they seen us around. Got them guessing about what's really going down. Yeah.
And if they found out that
we do what we do, girl, I doubt if they believed it was true. Yeah. So I'm thinking that we should just be good friends. If we continue this way, we'll only just hurt each other. So I'm thinking that we should just be good friends. Go through the motions so we don't undercover. Something about the way you look at me tells me that I just might be worthy of feeling you despite uncertainty, despite the way that you might hurt me. I wanna take your love and mix it with mine.
Yo, let's clap it up for super intern Steve over there.
I just wanna put
you had the feeling tonight.
Make sure that you appreciate me. If it's a
you know you at another Thursday
life,
night, bkswonradio.com. The throne.
Sexy situation.
Sexy situation. bkswonradio.com. I'm here with the beautiful ladies of Allure every Thursday night.
Hello.
So we're going to do the roll call. We're going to start to the far right, on my right. That one. That one. Who are you?
I'm Samantha.
Inside joke.
Yes, inside joke. What's up, world? It's Akisa.
It's Akisa in the building. Into my far left.
Hello, everybody. I'm Aaliyah.
Aaliyah is in the building. Yeah. Into the right of me. Baby Huey.
My name is Lala, and I'm from the Bronx.
Whatever, y'all. And again, it's
that
the
was your that was an indirect warning.
So,
exactly.
Again, welcome chat room rebels, everybody in the chat room.
Yes.
Callers, the official line is 646-233-1302. See, this is why I love it. Harmony. We are in sync with each other. Watch this. You are on the throne.
Sexy situation.
That's all I gotta say. You know what I'm saying? And we're gonna have some great discussion tonight. Also in the building. That's a surprise to me, actually. Cause see, I don't know. You know, this brother's so busy. When he say he coming through, I'd be like, you ain't coming through, man. You planning another industry takeover somewhere. You probably in Vegas somewhere, Atlanta somewhere. You know what I'm saying?
That's a good thing. Busy is good.
Yeah, no doubt. But he's here tonight. Big shout out to Shariff James is in the building.
Hi.
So make sure y'all tweet that out right now. Shariff James is in the building. Put it up on your Facebook status. That's family right there. Mission Entertainment. Shout out to my man Sporty.
Yes.
Sporty is in the building as well. Also, make sure your mics is on.
Yeah.
Because now that I know that you're here, I'm going to actually add your name to the layout.
You got some harmonizing over here.
Oh, all right.
Uh-oh.
That's
sometimes, you know, you gotta let the engineer be the engineer. You know, I got this. Yes.
No, we don't do that. None of the shows.
Absolutely. So now, y'all know what the topic is.
Yes, we do.
Who thought of this topic, by the way, before I tell the people?
We did.
No, I know somebody had to spearhead it, though.
Oh, it actually came from Akisa. We were reminiscing on some things.
Yeah. Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Really?
Like, oh, that might be good.
Oh,
she
must have
had some bad dates then.
Yeah, like the one y'all had yesterday.
Yesterday, like last night.
That was a bad date, the one we had last night?
I quit.
Really? You want to play me out like that?
You didn't even buy the popcorn.
I did. Mr. E, can you co-sign that I brought some of the popcorn?
Some of the popcorn.
That's what I quit.
First of all, the fact that I was trying to share with you and you acted like I did it and then you bit me, that's not nice.
Y'all were violent.
Wait.
I bit you just to show how good love evidence. Making would be for us in the future.
Oh, God. I don't want to hear this.
And I'm putting my Band-Aid away.
What's the muffin ears thingy?
Earmuffs.
Yeah, but really, yeah. really, it was a bad date.
Have you seen my baseball? Okay.
I can't.
See, you know, and that's what we're talking about tonight. We want to know the one thing. If Shariff or Sporty, and big shout out to Shariff. He's married. He always talks great things about his wife. I went to an Women's Empowerment Conference, and he said some beautiful things about his wife and everything, great. Man. And now, really great. Inspired me to really take dating seriously and all of that. You know
well,
what I'm saying?
If from last night, you didn't hear nothing he said. No.
For real.
Just totally, I deal with all types of disrespect here. That's all right.
All that inspiration wasted.
I'm so glad someone finally took you off the market. Finally. Jeez, every time I look at you, CeCe Peniston pops in my head. Finally, man.
I know. It's not going to be another good week.
Now, you're looking at my man Shariff.
Yes, we are.
The Sporty. In the building. Mission Entertainment. And real quickly, man, just brief the world on what you do and the great things you do with Mission Entertainment, man. Make sure your mic is on. Just flip that switch on the top.
We there?
Right. Oh, yeah.
Yes, clear. Check. Yeah. We put on signature annual events. We are an event marketing, event management company. And we're primarily focused on putting together theme affairs with annual models. So we're those individuals. We don't do weekly things or monthly, which can be great programs. We're the ones that kind of give you that anticipation. Like, when is that next event?
Right. Mm-hmm.
So that's our game right there. We've been doing it over 15 years. You know, so, yeah. Great.
So why are you nicknaming? Don't get me later.
Okay.
Right. But why are you nicknamed like the mayor of Newark? I heard two nicknames for you. The mayor of Newark.
Right.
And also the Diddy of Jersey.
Right.
I hope they mean that one in a good way.
They mean it in a good way.
Okay.
When they talk about the Diddy of Jersey, they're talking about, because Diddy does put on great parties. He put on great events and everything like that. So that's the association.
Okay.
Not the label owner Diddy with artists.
Gotcha.
Right,
okay.
right.
You don't want to compare.
Diddy's a bunch of bunch of divisions.
Yes.
Right. Yeah.
Multiple
yes.
versions
so you're
of Diddy.
The party. Okay, right. Gotcha.
So why do you feel as though he
represents the energy. He represents, without question, vision, entrepreneurship, persistence, determination. He's always been an individual that went after his dreams and his vision. He's been an inspiration. You know, a lot of people don't agree how he approached business. You know, he's probably picked up some ways of the industry, which unfortunately that's a different world.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, you know, he's been a man that's demonstrative, you know, goal set, goal accomplished.
Right, right.
You know, how he done it, that's another story.
Yeah. Right.
You know what I mean? But I think, you know, I'll be honest with you. I saw a magazine of did, like, this is like probably, 91, 92.
Mm-hmm.
He was on Uptown Magazine. He had this little cat like that.
Yeah.
That he had on, right? Mm-hmm. And it said millionaire, 22 years old. And I just thought that was phenomenal to see a young brother that was actually playing at that level.
Right.
So it was an inspiration for me to say, wow, wait a minute.
Right.
You know, what is he doing? Like, what game is he playing? And the bottom line, he's a hustler.
Yeah.
You know, he goes get it. So I represent that. A lot of individuals represent that, you know, in our community.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. Tell everybody what you're working on right now.
Okay.
Yeah. What's next, and even what's next after that, man?
Mm-hmm. Right. Oh yeah, we got Scott. We're just talking about it now. The latest project, we're very proud of this project. We've secured some real estate in Atlantic City. We're gonna be pulling our 9th annual Crystal All White experience. We don't call it a fair, it's an experience.
Nice.
We're in that
crystal. Yeah,
right. Sounds expensive.
Crystal.
Right. And we expanded it to a weekend function where you can come down and do one day, you can do 3 days.
Okay.
It's an atmosphere for you to bring your mate, your significant other, or you come down with the girls or the guys. We built that kind of culture where you're comfortable either way you go.
Okay. Yeah. That's nice.
Right, yeah. And singles, you know, a lot of, you'd be surprised how many people actually meet like-minded people. Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, they're like, why are you coming to the events no more? Arif, I got married, man.
That's
always been a proud thing.
Mission babies.
Yeah, you said the mission babies. So.
That is it.
So we're working on that. Very excited. It's 3 days. We got Lamar Rucker. Very proud of that piece there. He will be hosting the weekend.
When is this?
And Friends.
When is this now?
Lamar Rucker from Why Did I Get Married.
Yes, we know, Troy. So,
okay. Your husband is watching.
What time is Allure singing?
I love you.
Yeah. Saturday, 12 o'clock?
Well, actually, Lamar's going to be there Friday night, right?
Friday and Saturday.
See, I did my research.
Yeah.
Friday night.
What time is Allure on?
Friday night.
Friday
hour.
The same night. As long as Lamar's there, we're there. Hello.
So it's a signature event. We started in Washington, on D.C., on a boat called the Odyssey. It was a glass boat.
Okay.
Cool.
And everything we do, we try to create this wow factor and give you that experience. You know, we've been always willing to take risks and go out of the box.
Mm-hmm. Out of the box.
and to make sure that, you know, when you walked away, you go, what's next?
Right.
And then we built that from 20, 34 people to up to a couple of thousand over the years.
Right.
So we're proud. We're proud of that.
No doubt.
Has there ever been a time at the beginning where it wasn't as successful as you thought it was going to be and kind of got discouraged?
I wouldn't say discouraged. Sometimes you can be disappointed by results.
Yes. Okay. Mm-hmm.
And what we've learned is to kind of figure out what is success, right? So you have to kind of figure out and set a stance here. Not society success, not success for people judge, but what is success for you?
For you, right.
Okay.
So we actually had to say success, number one, is safety. Mm-hmm. Number two, to make sure that there was a vibe and energy. Number three, you know, we look at profit last. Could profit come and go?
Mm-hmm.
You know, did we meet expectation? You know, so we have a little criteria we came up with. But our first event, you know, this is, you know, the very first, like four people showed up at the bus ride. It was a learning curve. I was, you know, I had that Diddy spirit in me.
Yeah.
You
know, no doubt.
Kept going.
I'm going to be honest with you. The first ever mission event I went to as a BKS1 radio, you know, hosts and everything, just representing. And, you know, Shariff showing the love. And was like, okay, you and your team, boom, tickets, whatever. So, I went with my partner. And I got there. So it was an all-white affair. Mm-hmm. I had a little accident, right? So I had to mix a little white with some black, right? Right. Let me tell you, Shariff James takes his event seriously. He don't play. If he say all-white,
he means all-white.
If he say all-black, he mean all black. So that don't mean purple.
Right.
It don't mean brown. Yeah. I came up there. Now look.
I remember
myself on the back or nothing like that, but people know me. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt.
I do my thing. Either it's love or hate. They know me. But I came up in there, and Sharice, my man, he's a good brother, positive brother. He pulled me to the side, said, Norm, where's your wife?
Yeah.
I said, I got white pants on. You know, I had to wear a black shirt. I had to change.
We got that part.
He said, no, but where's your white? Salt white. I was like, bro, I had a little accident. He said, look, he gave me the head look and everything. But he gave me the look like, look, I'm going to let you in.
Because you
my man.
Yeah, right, exactly. You got to be a waiter.
You're going to be limited to where you go, buddy.
You're in the kitchen.
But nah, it was a great night. Great entertainment, great music.
Mm-hmm.
The whole ambiance was beautiful.
Was that at the waterfront or NJ Pack?
That was at the waterfront.
The waterfront, okay, gotcha.
I loved it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was just the vibe. They made you feel good.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah. We will be looking forward to coming to one of these events.
Yes.
And I think who performed that Nice and Smooth?
Right, okay.
Was up there. My people.
Right, I remember that.
Yeah, shout out to Smooth. I know him and his family listening right now. Right. Shout out to Smooth.
No doubt, shout
they,
out.
Yeah, Nice and Smooth. They performed and everything.
Shobie.
Yeah, they did their thing. Yeah. And but it was just a beautiful event. But that's please great. Just wear all white. If it's a white.
We don't care what a little
have
color.
Wait, so this white weekend, you have to wear white the whole weekend?
No, not at all.
Okay.
That's just Saturday, which is the thing.
Oh, okay.
Actually, it's masquerade, so we allow you to wear masks. It could be the mask
that
match
is great
shoe.
For Norm. That's right. Great
I had it
for Norm.
First, I had it for
no,
Norm.
I said it before you. And that's great for Norm.
Let's so they can tonight. Actually check out the event at crystalwhiterevel.com. That's Crystal Revel. CrystalWhiteRebel.com.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you in the chat?
Mission-entertainment.com.
No doubt. Say what's up to the people in the chat. Can you put that, what Shariff just said, in the chat?
For those that want to actually, we have a website designed to break the whole event down from nice. Dress code. It's music on each page. We got questionnaires. Mm-hmm. So we give you that platform. We treated it mm-hmm. where we make you say, you know what? I want to not only go to the event, but I want to follow this brand.
Cool.
Right. Because we're taking it serious.
Nice.
So.
Yeah,
that's great.
Yeah, you guys had me at the flyer. The flyer was real nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Let me ask you, who's going to be some of the performers there at the event this year?
Talk about Allure. Let's go.
See, hello. So I just want my percentage. That's all, because some reason I like y'all.
You love us.
Now, let me tell you. I'm going to say this hands down. It's not just because my man Shariff here.
Your percentage is follow the dress code and you won't go overboard. Because you don't know how to listen.
You know what? All right. Okay.
And
Shariff,
they sit
in the kitchen.
So people want to come in.
They're
I
want to
know what the
kitchen.
Topic is today. That's what
the topic is. The topic is your worst dating experience. Yeah. And what's the one thing a woman can do if you were dating her that would turn you off on a date? That would completely turn you off. And I'm going to tell my stories, and I
got
to read. I got 100 stories sent to me. I got 100 stories sent to me about what people did that just was turned off on a date.
Yeah.
Mine was some chick asked me for a pension.
Wait, look at Sporty.
They asked me, do I have a pension on the date?
What?
First date.
I saw that.
They asked me, the chick asked me, do you have a pension?
It's not good.
That wasn't good.
That's not good.
And then she asked me,
did you have one?
Shariff, Sporty, that she asked me, do I have life insurance?
Oh, she was trying to kill you.
She was trying to kill you.
First date.
Wow. That's a financial size up.
Definitely.
She was preparing
that's
for your
financial size up.
But wow. I'm going to lose mad cool points which you brought in.
Lord,
you
told
here's where all the respect is going to go out the window that you may have for me. I moved the rent.
That was the one.
Four years.
Wait, not with the house.
Not the one with the house.
Hello,
right?
But I moved.
Warning, tell us why. Oh,
wait. I was so intrigued by this girl, and she was beautiful, and she was Puerto Rican, African American. I got a weakness.
Oh,
Jesus. And I'm keeping real on this show.
Oh,
and
like this.
And I just said, you know what? Like, even though she asked me those questions, I'm going to have a second date with her. And had the second date with her.
Oh, what is wrong?
The second date, she cooked for me.
And what did she put in it?
She cooked for me.
Exactly.
Yo, my mother would love you. You know what my mother said?
She put voodoo.
Can I tell you what my mother said?
Louisiana?
When I told my mother about the second date, she said,
I love Louisiana.
Don't you eat that girl's cooking. She said, my mother said, don't you eat that girl's cooking.
For real.
You don't know that well. You agree with my mom's? You agree?
He looks scared and she's gone.
Do I agree with what?
Hello.
With my mom. My mom said, don't you eat that girl's cookie.
Absolutely.
After she asked about
your life insurance.
What she talking about? Listen.
Who does that?
Like she said Louisiana. My people from there.
But can I tell you, I think I was the exception because even though she came off with those questions and she had children, she had two kids.
She turned out to be her daddy. Who that is?
She was real petty.
My baby daddy.
She was very petty.
She was looking for a baby daddy.
And quick arguments, quick to argue. But she was a great woman. She's the type of woman that get out in the backyard and rake the leaves with you.
Are you still
with
her? Are you serious?
This was a while ago.
Okay, so. Because so not for nothing, you bring
those
up her
I
life.
Said she was petty. We broke up because she was petty. I would come in the house. I'm a studio person.
You ain't do your homework.
I would come in the house 3 a.m.
Thank you.
And she would be ready to fight me and be waiting on the bed.
Okay, knowing that you were coming from work?
Yes.
She's a loser.
First of all, the fact that she asked you all those questions, like all those other reasons, shouldn't even justify for you to say, oh, she was a good woman, though. She asked you if you had a pension.
So are there red flags? In come on,
hell
you
yeah.
know,
are you, she had a quilt yes, around yes, you.
Yes. People
bruh,
pointing.
You, bruh, listen to me, Shariff. Shariff.
Wow.
Bro.
Wait, you said she
Sporty,
what?
She was,
She was petty.
That don't mean thank you. Thank you.
She was crass.
In my weakness, she said the way she said.
I might get shot going up out of here. She said, if I get into this conversation.
Because bad doesn't always mean good.
No, you got to get into it. You got to get into it.
Dog, what bad mean?
Thank you.
Exactly.
Like my grandfather said, what look good ain't good, what smell good don't taste good.
But look, at the dinner table that night, after she asked me about the pension, she said, She said, Poppy, I'm getting up. You want me to get you anything?
Oh, because she called him Poppy. He got excited.
And I was
she like was planning said, your death while she was doing it.
Me and Shariff were talking about this the other day. Yeah. You met her representative.
Right. So let me ask you this.
Go ahead.
Wow.
Look, he can't get it out.
He can't even get it out.
He's lost. You lost.
I already knew Shariff was going to get me.
Hi, Poppy.
Are you a wiser man now?
Oh, please. I'm 20 times wiser.
Okay. So what was your lesson learned?
We don't believe you. You need more people.
My lesson learned is you never look at the surface. You got to look deeper than the surface.
You got to.
And if she asks you about life insurance,
that was
walk
my
away.
Lesson.
Exactly.
But although,
if you say anything nice, I'm turning your mic off.
For real.
I was about to say something nice about it.
No, right. No.
That's no more nice. Listen.
But if you would have asked her that question, what you think she would have said? Like, I'm going to tell you, my thing is, you get a lot of females, they quick to ask you questions. But if I ask her a question, they get mad like me. Just to test you out, I'll be like, before you ask me to take you, I ask you first just to see where your head is at. Mm-hmm. If she say, well, I won't mind taking out, my money ain't right, I'm cool with that. I'll take you out all day long. But if you be like, listen, boy, you better take me out first, this and that, and
that's
and
this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, yeah, trying to get me before
off.
I get you.
Right. Yeah.
Now,
that's a turn off.
Now. When I asked her reason why she asked me those questions, this is what she said.
Oh, Jesus.
She said, I want to know,
how to
Norm,
you.
That you care about your future.
No, she wouldn't know how
I
to
want to
you.
Know. Oh, exactly.
She got
I want
you with
to
the
know.
She got you with the
how
getting.
I'm going to kill you and bang.
I want to see if I want to see if you're concerned about your future.
Because I'm concerned about mine.
Because I'm concerned about mine and my kids need sneakers.
When you there, she did that face.
Jesus.
All I want to tell you is to wear a mask at the mission boat ride.
Wear a helmet. Yeah. You need a helmet. Can he wear a helmet?
He can wear a helmet.
Okay.
Can he come on the yellow short bus also?
I like y'all. So look, what's y'all name that to him this week?
Why would you, what?
Because
you why are you giving them
it?
The answer?
That's
like,
not
that's
the
so
game.
Stupid. Who says, I'm going to sing, but call in. We're not telling you.
We're not telling you, so you can say it.
Okay, so just go ahead. Go ahead.
All right, well, we're gonna stop talking about the trifling Puerto Rican chick, right? And we're going to go back to Shariff.
Thank you.
I was trying to deflect
we did ask
that
him
off
a question.
Me because, yo, Shariff hit me with the question like,
nah.
He brought it back to
me. He basically said, no, is your ass smarter now?
Right. Pretty much.
Yeah. So pretty I tried much. To deflect that because he was justified in asking that question.
Yes. Yeah, because even still, you're trying to, yet. But she was a nice person.
But stop.
What
color
is the stop sign?
So here's the deal. Hold on. Let me say this.
Red.
Let's say this. In fairness, in his defense.
Hear me out.
Don't
defend
him. Hear me out.
Okay.
Before making a statement, I asked the question first. Mm-hmm. There was a reason for that. So now I can say what I'm about to say.
Okay.
I think we all have been there where we allow the external aspect of individuals to deceive us. Because we lack sometimes the wisdom or the experience, and you get caught up, maybe not in the looks, but some of the external things of a person, maybe status, their affiliations, so forth and so on, at a young age. Now, I don't know what age this happened.
Yes, how old were you, Norm?
I don't know. So, ladies, let me ask you a question. So, you never, I mean, the time you've been into dating, you know, we ain't talking about age. You ever been in a situation where you realized that you focused on the wrong attributes of the person and made a bad judgment call? Have you been there?
Honestly, me personally, I've never been, like how you said, status or whatever. I've never been a type
when
of person.
I'm just using it for an example.
No, I know. I'm just saying overall.
Just never looking at the core characteristics of the person.
Well, I can't say that only because I was bamboozled. Like,
I say
that because in a relationship, you really don't get to know the real person until after 2 years. That's when we start putting on our scarves. And
I totally disagree with that.
I don't.
I'm with you.
And let me tell you why. The problem sometimes is that there's tests that you can actually take a person through, mm-hmm. right? For that person to demonstrate who they really are. Sometimes we don't know what test to give a person.
Right.
So we get caught up in their representation, like Sporty said, mm-hmm. and because a lot of times, just from the a male's perspective, a lot of men are still in game mode. Yeah. And sometimes you don't realize he's in game mode.
I agree with that.
Because women sometimes come across so vulnerable and so desperate at times. And naive. That's all I'm saying. So the word is naive.
Right.
And he was naive at that particular moment. And so I said in his defense, because he lacked the wisdom or the experience or he haven't had that hard lesson, he got caught in that. And I think we all have been in this situation where we've been, and you said bamboozled, meaning that someone lied.
Yeah. I mean,
okay,
I
so watch this. Can I
it
tell
was
you
a
something?
Facade.
Okay,
well, that comes with immaturity that and experience.
Right, that's all I'm saying.
It happens on both sides of the
Yeah, but that's she kind of put herself out there by the questions that she asked him.
Right. So,
that was, you know what I'm saying?
And he just totally ignored
that. Right.
He saw that bad Puerto Rican.
Yeah, most people don't get that because the person is so busy lying. So they're putting on that facade. So you don't even get that. But she just put it all out there. I'm killing you. That's what I want to know.
I ain't even mad at her because she kept it real from the beginning.
Yeah, right.
But you know what? Can I tell you something? That's not who she turned out to be after four.
Yeah, because
four
she was
going
to get your life insurance.
Well, how long you been married to?
Don't
I wasn't married. I didn't marry.
Let's get clear. When did she ask that? The first date?
Yes.
The first date. That okay. Yes.
Who asked that question?
Yes. Now, but listen.
That's like
I'm not defending her because the reason why I brought it up because. That should have drew a red flag. And Florina is in the building from the Bad Girls Club. Bad Girls Club, Oxygen Channel, in the building.
All right.
She ready already. Right now, I'm building with my man. What's up, mama? I'm building with my man, Shariff. What's up, family?
How we doing, sis? What's going
Don't
on?
Don't get him
without,
a booty shot. Yeah, move, get Flo. Move, Flo.
Have a seat. We're going to bring you in a minute. She came in with the ruckus.
She crashed it.
And she a boxer. And she a boxer, Shariff.
Interview bombing.
Okay.
Interview bombing.
So, yeah. I mean, my whole thing with that, yes, that was red flags. But I believe in always giving a person the benefit of doubt. So even though you may see what you may deem as red flags.
No, hell no.
Thank you, Shariff. He was with you until you realized first date. No. Come on.
Okay, so here's the deal. Let me explain something to you. We all got mouths. We like used cars, right? So we all have issues. Let's be clear.
Okay.
At different levels.
Yeah,
at different levels.
Okay. So
exactly. if you go buy a used car and you get caught up in the smell of it, the shiny shit on the wheels, and how it look, and with the bullshit the salesman is selling you without popping the hood, really looking at the things that can allow the car to go a distance,
right?
Because you're going on a journey, you're going to eat that.
Right.
So it's no benefit of the doubt if someone is coming with the intention from the door to take advantage of you. There's no benefit of the doubt.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you, Shariff.
But here's what I'm saying.
No.
And I'm not defending.
No one can help you.
I'm not defending. Look, I'm not trying to defend this chick.
Please stop.
And I want somebody. Please call in 646.
Somebody please.
233-1302.
I'm going to give you your number.
We're going to get that again. 646-233-1302. I'm not defending her. But what I am saying is, 4.5 years, she turned out to be a decent woman and wasn't on no monetary things because she held her share down monetarily. But at the same time, her biggest problem was, in the relationship, she was petty. And I couldn't do anything. If I went out with my nephew, she wanted to go. If I went out with my brother,
she
wanted to go.
She was just trying to have a reason to be angry.
Why did y'all end? Why did the relationship end?
Because she was petty. I couldn't take it no more. She wouldn't want to argue with me.
Okay. But she wasn't the one for you. She wasn't
decent enough.
You brought a car with a bad starter. And you heard it clicking from the door.
Exactly.
There you go. Now,
it started smoking time he got on the turnbuckle.
Now, look, Shariff, you
but he was listening to the music. He sold you on a fucking Bose system. That was in the car.
Now listen.
No, and then he bought it with the little tree air freshener in it.
Yeah, see, I'm going to have to get Shariff right now.
He got excited with the black ice.
Now listen. Before you got your diamond, though.
Go ahead.
Before you got your diamond.
No, I'm going to leave that alone because he's going to tear you up.
Before you got your diamond, you didn't give anybody second chances.
I had my naive stage. And we all have.
You got to go through something to know what you're
talking
about.
We got you on the naive stage if the person lied to you from the
gate.
You
see, I cleared that air from the door. So I leveled the playing field from the door. I just want to make sure you learn first because that'll change the dynamic.
Not for nothing, Norm, where you messed up was... Because like we said, most people put on a facade, so you don't get the real in the beginning. She gave it to you right then and there. She showed you the person she was right there.
But you know what? I'm really on this show. No, really. I'm really on the Green Sexy Situation show with Allure and Storm.
Hey, no.
I'm defending her.
I need to ask you a question.
All right, well.
How long did it take before you... You know,
four and a half years.
Your head on that pillow.
Four and a half years. Oh.
Before I hit it, we could keep it real. All
right. Well, shit.
After you she asked that same night because she was going to be
the... You hit it less than a
beneficiary on
the... No, I hit it. Be honest with you. Be honest with you. I hit it in 3 weeks.
All right. You hit it in 3 weeks. Yeah. You got the representative. Because she called herself putting it on you.
Exactly.
To bring you in. And you saw that.
She got caught up with the red snapper.
This and that, that and this.
She did have long hair.
And you was like, damn.
You know what I learned?
And she said,
Poppy. You know what happens? You know what happens? Watch this. There's a lesson in this, right? We all have, and you got to be really careful. This is actually sometimes your dream and your vision and things you really want can actually work against you. Why?
Oh, yeah.
Because sometimes it can appear and it's not really what it is.
Right.
So a lot of times, even guys, right, we got this like or women got this preference that we want and it actually looked like it showed up.
Right.
So when it showed up, he just only looked at one aspect of it. Oh my God, she's beautiful. She's giving me the time and the day. This is it. Let me go for it.
Right.
And what you did was you compromised. You compromise what you needed
you
as a man.
You compromise your life.
What you needed.
Yeah,
there's certain needs that she couldn't meet.
See, and you know what?
You needed that Puerto Rican in your life.
If I was listening, if I was you sitting over there, and you was telling me that story, I would kind of, say the same things to a point. But my thing is, I always got to go deeper. Into somebody's character. I got to go a little bit deeper because sometimes
they got to give you a why to do that. They got to give you a why. What was your why to do that?
My why to do that. My
red
why.
Snapper.
My why to do that because I met her. Before I went on this date with her, I worked with her for about maybe 6 months, and I got to see and I got to know her, and I look at a woman by how she treats her kids, and. She treated her daughter and her son so good and was overly concerned about them and whatever. So when she hit me with those red flags, which I knew when I was sitting there at the table, when she said that, I was like...
Oh, this is the crime scene? Dang.
Yeah, I was like, she, you know what? I'm going to do a second date. I'm going to do a second date. She turned me off with that, but with her, I said, I'm going to do a second date because... She got to be a decent person the way she treats her kids.
Wait, y'all worked at the same job?
Wait,
yes,
no,
we did.
Yeah.
So she knew you had a pension.
Hey, no.
Exactly.
No, she didn't. No.
I think
she Googled you.
She didn't.
Wait, he just said that they were working together for what, 6 months?
Yes.
So that means, so she did reversal. You knew it for 6 months, so she hid who she was for 6 months. Y'all went on your first date. She hit you with the, here I am.
Hey, no.
You still went.
Listen.
What?
I'm she still got effect on you because you
yeah.
still.
Yes,
listen,
I said that.
Listen,
going hard.
No, you, listen, no. You don't. We sitting over here. I'm watching you.
Yeah.
And you.
His eyes lit up.
Yeah.
Rob, you're taking up with this girl. You
no,
going
no, no, no.
In,
because
like,
she fits the topic. She fits
okay,
the topic. But
the
trust
topic,
me.
Yeah, but not for a whole hour. We're not going to talk about her for a whole hour.
Yeah, I wanted to going on y'all. I was trying to deflect with the sing Allure, but y'all didn't want to catch this.
No, we're not falling for that.
And then Reed. Hit me with the.
Did you learn
so,
from it?
Yeah, until
did
he
you
said.
Learn from it?
Yeah,
like,
until
oh,
he figured
damn,
out it was the
is,
first day.
That's going to dictate what we talk about.
Yeah.
I need to know if I'm dealing with the new version.
Okay, so let's talk about.
She still got that stake in your heart.
I got to set the conversation
so
up.
So she's already established that she's somewhere smashing her arm in a fridge.
Right.
Let's go back.
You're a bad date experience.
He danced around the question.
He did.
He did the diddy.
I haven't been
a date. Take that.
Before your diamond. Before the diamond. Before your diamond.
We got
right.
And
much respect to your diamond.
I'm sorry.
Right.
And
no doubt.
And he has a gym that he speaks about a lot.
Yes.
And
happy birthday. My wife's birthday was
happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Moan. First lady of missions.
Now, before your diamond. I know you had a bad date experience.
A couple of roughs.
That's been amazing.
Call in with your bad date experience too.
I was playing. I don't think I had. Oh,
come on, Shariff.
Come on, Shariff. I got to fall back on this.
What no, when you said let's define.
Can we do the Michael Jackson that. dancing?
When you said bad experience.
Just a bad date experience.
It could be funny. It doesn't have to be disaster.
I'm just trying to
stab you, and you know, it doesn't have to
took
be like
your, funny actually for life.
Took your wallet.
We're talking about almost in my teens, because before my wife, I was with my daughter's mom for 3 years, so there was no dating there. So I was a young guy. You know, I got married and had my daughter early.
Oh, okay.
So it's like hard to reflect on them situations.
Okay.
I did have one that was just turned me off. I had one of them. Like, I remember I had a young lady. I can't remember her name. And we got into an argument.
No, don't say names.
No, I'm not. We actually got into an argument.
I'm saying names.
Blow her up. Me too.
Listen.
Oh, Sporty.
And I was hungry, right? I can't remember. We was coming. I'll never forget. It was daytime. So I was like, you know, I'm going to McDonald's. I'm going to grab me something real quick. Quick, some nuggets. That's what I wanted. Mm. Do you want something? And she just ordered a lot of shit on the menu.
I can't.
And I just thought, I was just turned off. Like, yo, why is you ordering extra this and extra that and extra this and extra that? And that was me. I just think it just was it to me. It just was tack. I don't know why. I just felt some kind of way about it. And she was like, you acting on like that. I said, yo, you like ordering everything on the menu. Like, you like you ain't never ate before. And
oh, so he could never go. We could have never been on a date.
So
like
she was a user.
No.
I just didn't get it. You know, I didn't have a problem with you ordering, but it was everything large. Give me this. Super give me size. That. Super size.
She could have.
But it was McDonald's.
She was trying to show you something. Wait a minute.
Shariff, did you buy it for her?
I was young. I was like a teenager. No.
Did you buy it for
her? I can't remember. I think I did, yeah. I was just mad. I'm like, yo, you greedy, yo.
Was she bad at least?
She was decent. She was decent. All right. She was decent. Oh, she was decent.
Yeah, she probably wasn't gonna get enough.
I was on a date last night. I had a greedy ass date. Greedy. She was greedy. Very.
All
greedy.
He bought her was popcorn, though.
Mm-hmm. He didn't even buy the popcorn.
True that.
So I feel you on that. Now, okay. So when you realize she was just greedy. Was you at that point like ain't gonna be no?
I just think if I don't know you, like do your thing.
I don't know you like that.
Right, do your thing, but you don't go in.
Hey, yeah.
Maybe but it was McDonald's. It wasn't like it was Le Chateau.
Yeah, but he was young.
Yeah,
he
I was young.
So
yeah.
McDonald's
I still
is like
no,
I can't get that. I can't get with
yeah.
that.
So I'm sitting here and I'm like, and I, like I she eat. Talking over me. I'm like, yo, you really ordering all of this? So,
and she's talking to the cashier.
So, yeah. Like,
so let's go.
She didn't even ask me like, what do you have? Yeah.
So what
can I get?
So what you learned from that?
Are you never wiser now?
No. He like this. Dollar menu.
Dollar menu, boo boo.
No, I don't even eat right. McDonald's no more.
Good job.
She turned you off from McDonald's, didn't she?
Well, no, I just, it's just a help.
Scared
of listen, okay. I don't know about y'all. I really want to know.
Yes.
I want to know Flo's
bad flow.
We got Florina from the Bad Girls Club season 1.
We finally got
when
our
she came up in here, I got scared. She just
scary. I want to know your. Give it a mic.
Yeah, give it that mic.
Pick it up.
Actually,
hold on.
You know what, Sporty, look, y'all gonna be here for the show, so y'all may wanna.
I got so many. You wanna know something? I'm not even being sarcastic. I had so many bad dates. I'm trying to think of which one I should talk about.
I just want to know, was he the problem or was you the problem?
It be like that.
That's the question. Good question.
He was the problem.
Good answer.
Yeah, he was the problem.
Whoa.
He was the problem. Okay. All right. Okay. This is the story I always tell everybody. This is the date I always tell everybody. Okay. So this Albanian guy comes and he's like, he wants to date me. He comes to my mom's, like, you know, he did it Albanian style. He comes, gets me, whatever. So this was a real date. I don't consider the rest of them date. It was just chilling, smoking blunts. Those weren't dates. Those were just like, let's just chill, you know, go play some pool, whatever. No, but this was a date. And he picks me up and then he's like, all right, I got a surprise for you and stuff. I'm like, okay. So We go and we end up by the MTV Awards, the 2004 MTV Awards. He laid out the red carpet. That was his job for a living.
Oh, okay. Okay.
He laid out the red carpet. Like, he put it
like
down.
Literally, so he laid it
literally put the red carpet down. So, you know, that's the Albanian stuff, you know, roofing, carpet, and all that.
There you go.
Get that money, though.
I need someone. Go,
yo, I got you, girl. Okay, hook up right here. So we get there, and I'm like, oh, snap. I'm like, this what's up right now. He's like, yo, you got backstage passes, whatever, whatever. But it was bad, but it ended up being really good. So the kid's like, he takes me behind stage, and I'm chilling with him, and all of a sudden his friends come. He's introducing me as his wife, trying to make out with me, holding on to me, like holding on for dear life, my hand
frontin',
like this.
He frontin'.
Frontin', like, so, yo, I just met you, like, that day, and you're grabbing me like I'm wifey, and he's, like, holding me and saying, this is my girlfriend, you know what I'm saying? Like, to me, that was real uncomfortable, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And the whole time, he just kept pushing up on me, so I just got annoyed. I got fed up. I literally walked away from him, and he's like, "Yo!" And I'm acting like everybody's pushing me back, but really, so I'm like, I can't, I don't know what happened. So I get pushed all the way back, and I end up at a part where all like the people were like doing interviews and stuff like that, like, you know, J Lo's sister and all that time, and I ended up there, and then I ended up by myself having to take a train home from New Jersey somewhere. Got lost. I was just all messed up in the game. That was the worst day ever, but it was the best because I ended up like right by everybody, all the famous people, and I was like hugging, like I was hugging 50 Cent, I was hugging all of them. I was like, hey, they're like, hey,
who are you?
I was like, hey, what's up, 50? What's up? He's like, I'm like, yeah, what's up? And I'm hugging him. I start walking out. I'm like, I don't even know how I got in here. But it's like, how'd you get in here? I'm like, I don't know. Like, I just did. But you know, so that was it. But I got worse days, but they're just, I can't talk about.
So
it.
So what's a date that you can admit? Miss Bad Girls Club Season 4, you can admit that you were the bad one on the date.
That's
that
a big
you
step.
Were the bad
say
one on the date.
None of them, none of them.
Oh, me, yeah. Well, one time I got, one time. I don't even drink, so when I don't drink for a reason because I get retarded. So this is why I don't drink. Cause the night,
that sangria.
The night I can't drink that sangria, I'll get drunk for real. The night I went to a club with this guy, like, it was a date, we went out to eat, whatever, everything was fine. So he had me drinking mad wine. I'm like, yo, you shouldn't give me any more because I don't drink. He's like, no, you're good drinking. I'm like, okay, when I'm throwing up in your car, don't say shit. So I'm drinking. Then we get right by his car, and as we're talking, I just threw up. I was like, bleh.
Oh my God.
I just got back in the car, and I was like, no, I'm fine. I was like, no, I'm fine. I got in the car, and I threw up in his car, and oh my.
Damn.
Yeah, that was my fault. That was a bad day for him, not for me.
Did he go out? Let me ask you. Did he go out with you again?
Help.
Smart man.
He was like, it was my fault. I was getting you drunk. Like, because I was like, oh, I'm sorry if you never want to talk to me again, you know? I'm so sorry. But no, he called me again. He was like, it's all my fault. I'm sorry. And then we went out again. He was like, you're not getting any drinks.
Wow.
So he learned.
Yeah. Wow.
He learned, Shariff. He learned from his experience.
I mean, like I said, yo, there's worse dates, but I can't talk about it. Sister will kill me.
Oh, we understand.
Keep those under.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Now, Sporty. Aww. Sporty, I know you had a bad day, bro. Yeah.
Come on, Sporty.
Come on, Sporty.
Yeah, because
I got a funny date.
When we sit you down, we have some more things to ask you.
I won't say your all name. So
yeah. Oh, man. I got so many bad days.
Tell us the worst one.
The worst one?
Oh. The one that sticks in your head, like, in the front.
What sticks in my head? Back in the day, I was with this girl. We was going to movies.
We can't hear you.
What's up?
No, I'm messing with him.
Right? I don't even know what size her breast was.
What?
Nah, listen. It's serious. Right? So we driving and stuff, going down 109, and she said, listen. She said, I want to show you this picture, but you might crash the car. You know, so I'm trying to play hard. I'm like, boy, I ain't gonna crash this, that, and this. Man, listen. She showed me this picture somehow or another. She had a picture where her breast was in the back of her.
What?
Oh, my God. That is
no,
awesome.
That is not
that's
true.
That's a bad day.
Listen, she had it.
You had airbags in the car
and
already.
And I'm like, I'm driving a stick shift.
Was she like 300 pounds?
Nah, she just was, you know how some chicks
big,
just, yeah,
big
right?
Boobies.
So but to
I'm,
the
I'm
back.
Trying to, listen, but this ain't the story, so I'm trying not to, you know, crash the car. I'm shaking the car, jerking this stuff. Her stuff was like, I'm like, damn. So we get to the movies and everything. This was back in the day, they had Perfect Amboy movie open.
Oh, I remember that.
So we're in the movies, watching the movie. You know how the movie, you watch the movie and just get real quiet, like they're showing the sky or something. Why she asked me that? Do I eat stuff? In front of everybody, and the whole movie's turned around and looked at me. I slid down in the chair. I put my jacket up like this. Everybody laughing and stuff. I was like, you know what?
Was she cute?
Yeah, she was
out. That is not the... Is that
the
end all be all?
That's how Norm got caught out there.
Stupidity.
That's how everybody gets caught out there.
Because she could do booby tricks.
First of all, Storm Norm does not... Let me say this now.
Yo, she could turn double dutch with her boobs.
On Radio, Storm Norm does not like this.
I went to the bathroom and never came back.
Yeah.
What? Oh. I was embarrassed. Oh, I was like, the whole movie turned around and was laughing. You could hear people, and I was like, yo, he doing this?
Wow.
Oh, that's good.
I slid down the seat so fast. I said, listen, I got to go to the bathroom. I'll meet you at the car.
You a nice guy. That wouldn't embarrass me. That wouldn't embarrass me.
Man.
At that point in life.
Oh, okay.
He said he was younger.
Backtrack.
Okay.
Yeah, at that point, like, that wouldn't, like...
Man, I got so many bad days, friends.
I don't judge nobody. You can't judge people.
But like I said, you live and you learn. Like I said, I'm glad, you know, I grew up in the street, so I'm glad I learned a lot at a young age. Mm-hmm. You got some cats right now, been married for 30, 40 years. They wife left them.
And they just get in the game
and don't know how to play the game.
Yeah,
because
it's
a whole
new.
Different
yeah,
ball game.
It's new.
Right. That's just like these. Yeah, yeah. That's like these ladies right now want to be cougars. They get these young boys. Listen, I'm gonna tell you, they get these young boys. These old ladies put it on these young boys, and they can't handle it.
Right.
They ask them if they have life insurance.
They can't handle it. Then next thing you know, the young boy breaking out their window, carbon, and that. Now you. 60 years old, don't know which way to go.
I
see it all the time. They call
their son to get them.
Now, real quick, it's 12 o'clock. It's 12 o'clock, and what we're doing, this is our new segment.
Already?
Yes, it's our new segment where Laura sings something, and y'all got to guess the name of it, the artist.
I get to hear them sing, oh my God. I'm so
confused. Who picks the song, they do?
Yeah, they're gonna sing something. So like, y'all could guess. But you know what? If somebody in the chat room or a caller calls in, we give them like 5 minutes.
Anybody in the chat room? Cause
yes.
Where they at?
Yes, he's reading the comments tonight.
I need a comment from somebody in the chat room because y'all are awfully quiet out there. This Mission Entertainment. Let's make it happen.
Okay. From guest 1762, I love Flo. Follow me on Twitter at
Flo.
On Twitter
Flo,
at
Flo.
Rocky Balboa Sun _ Sun. What else we got?
Sylvester Stallone.
Rocky fans still loves Flo.
Let's get it popping.
Then some more said, "All right, Flo, what's up next? After you win money on current show, are you up for any other shows or more kids?"
Call in right now. Ask her. 646-233-1302. Go ahead.
All right. Guess 1762 said, "Why did you say Rocky's stepdad? That's mean."
That's it.
Oh, wow. What?
Go. Scroll up. Yeah, scroll.
Keep
scroll
down.
Yeah, scroll or scroll. Yeah, to some of the early ones about. We want to hear somebody's comment about a date.
A date?
Any date comment. Read any date comment.
Wait until you're in the seat.
Yeah.
That's it. If her name is Danielle, do not read none of them. That's what I was talking about the whole time.
How you gonna
shop? Because I can do that.
No, you start feeling. She. You
somebody
sworn.
Said pics can be taken at the end. Relax. The pictures.
Easy.
Hey, that's what it was on the chat.
All right. Going in the chat.
Shut up.
Somebody in the chat put in a date story. We want to hear your bad date story.
You talking about flicks?
You talking about flicks and all this?
Ladies, are we going to hear your bad date stories?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
So yes, we're gonna get to them. Yeah, I tried to save the goodies for last.
Just now, we have not.
Man. You got you out the way early.
Because he knew he was going to take about an hour to get it out.
He has more, trust.
You don't understand. Like,
and then she showed up, and then.
Every topic that's about bad this or bad relationship or this and that, we spend the first hour and 15 minutes on the imperfect storm.
That's
okay.
You know what? That is.
It's not a lie. Stop. Don't start.
Good or bad, correct? Good or bad, Dave?
Yeah. Anyway.
Yes. Anyway.
Good or bad. Yes. Can we get that song out, please?
Maria Conchita Alonso ruined your life.
This one is easy, so y'all should be able to get this quick from the first line. Come on, guys. Okay? Ready?
Artist and the name of it.
You got the artist and the name of the song?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm bad. Ready? I'm out of this.
You may be able to get one of them, though.
This is easy. They got this. Come on, callers. I know y'all got this. It's
quick and easy.
Yes.
Ready?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, y'all get a free BKS1 t-shirt. Forget it.
What you find now?
I think I love you.
What you feel now?
I feel I need you.
What you know now? To be real. Ooh, your love's for real now.
Sorry, allergies. Wait, one more time.
Nah.
We got it.
Nah.
Okay, so
they,
no.
They, it. They wasn't yeah. supposed to get all that.
Yeah.
So you got to find out.
My allergies.
Artist Allegra. And name of the song.
Wait, last week I forgot the lyric.
All right, put it in the chat if you know the name of the song.
And the artist.
And the artist. In the chat, you'll get a BKS1 Radio t-shirt. All right? And call in. Speak to Flo. Yeah. Florina is in the building.
And yes, let us know about your worst date, Jim.
Yes.
Or your best one. Or a funny one.
646-233-1302.
Okay, so let's go for now until somebody calls and show Facebook some love, because you never do that.
Go
yeah,
with
yeah, Facebook. Yeah.
Oh, yes. I'm going to read the Facebook comments.
Yes. Okay, let's see.
All right.
Got to get a good one.
Let's see if I find
it. Carry on until I find
it. Oh, he has it.
Oh, I got plenty. I got it up.
My date's teeth came out.
Oh,
there you go.
By Trey.
Trey. Wow. And he tried to kiss her at the end of the day.
Oh my God. Wait, came out like when?
Well, she said that they almost popped.
We in the chat room.
Yeah, I'm in the chat room right now.
Wow.
She said my date's
eating was she?
All right, what happened?
How old was he?
Please call in and tell that story.
Yeah, Trey, you gotta call in, Trey.
How old was he?
Trey, you gotta become a cougar.
Trey, you gotta break that down.
Yeah, because I need to know why that happened.
No problem.
We need to know at what point.
Okay, wait.
We just want to know the point.
Did she buy a piece of corn?
Yeah.
I have to read this one because Harold is constantly going in.
Okay,
we got to get Harold. Harold, if you're listening, you need to call in because every single time we post a topic up, he's like, he goes off. He said, I had a chick tell me that her rationale for me paying for everything whenever we went out was that she was old fashioned. But this heifer was a bank manager. wait. Yo, I love this dude. He's so funny. This heifer was a bank manager and my ass was a store detective at TJ Maxx. wait, he said hashtag pre-cop. Hashtag pre-HRJR grind.
Yo.
Oh my God.
Wow. Look, here's my thing.
Deuces. Sorry.
We in 2000. This is 2013.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I think the playing field needs to be even now or whatever. If a woman, look, if I take a woman out on the first date,
completely.
I got you.
I got you.
But there's nothing wrong. All I want to say is there's nothing wrong
absolutely
with a woman
yes
picking up the tab every now and then.
And I must say, women, one thing we have to stop doing is the fake, I'm about to pay, and you better say, no.
Right.
I'll go in my purse.
Who does that?
A lot of women do that. They go in their purse, and you're supposed to go.
You've been away from the whole scene for a minute, man.
Yeah.
You don't know what goes on in this dating world.
They said they act like really? They need to
let me
stuff
be clear.
Go ahead.
So they actually fake like they pay.
They rummage in their bag as if they're looking for their wallet.
And you're supposed
to wait till you're going
to
say, oh, no, I got it, babe.
So give me the point of that.
To make you think I was going
to
help you.
To give you the impression, Norm, that I was going to go half on a baby with you, but
nah.
I was waiting
for you. So what happens if the guy be like, all right, he don't respond.
Then you just sit in the kitchen washing dishes, you ask him to do outs.
Unless straight you work up at the bank.
So they really gamble that. Like,
yeah, they take a chance. They
yeah
take a chance.
Really?
Yeah. 9 times out of 10, we win it, though.
Yeah, we do.
I can tell you something.
Well, no, yeah, they're going to win it.
I'm going to tell you something that I'll admit.
He said Spanish.
No. They're going to win.
What, she faked that too?
Hey.
No.
Are you serious?
I'm going to tell you something that I'm going to admit. I'm going to keep it real. The worst thing that I did, I played my own self out for. There was this girl I was trying to get with for a minute. Now, I was younger. Yes, I was younger. But I was always in the studio game. So I had my own studio, everything. And I didn't have the money like that. I didn't have money, man, like that. So she wanted to go out. She finally said yes. So she said yes. I didn't have the money. Couldn't get it from my mother. My boys wouldn't lend it to me. None of that. Whatever. Storm Norm went and took a piece of my studio equipment, and I sold it. I sold my DAP machine when DAP machines was.
Wow.
I sold my DAP machine to take her out. She wanted to go to a certain place and to a certain concert.
Oh, man.
And I sold it.
Wow.
I took her out.
Okay. See,
she's Puerto Rican too.
And she was.
Was she?
And she wasn't. Look, she wasn't even worth it. She didn't even appreciate that after that. So it's like, couldn't get my DAP machine back. Nothing.
You see, I don't understand why people from the gate just can't be honest. Like, if I can't afford it,
right? So you
we can just say, listen, hey, right now I can't afford it. We're going to have to maybe just do something a little bit more chill out. So cool. We'll go out next time when...
And I could have took her on something simple, why sell but she didn't want to... She named the place she wanted to go. And it
you
was
get a lot of red flags, God, brother. You get a lot of red flags.
Goes back to Norman not doing his homework.
Not for nothing. 23 years old.
I was about to say, he said DAP machine, so I'll give him a pass.
Norm, I swear to God, if you was...
That's when we started with...
If you were dating a bull, you would live. You know that,
huh?
Right?
If I what?
If you went out on a date with a bull, you would live.
You funny.
Because red flag and all, you still be like, yeah, baby, come. Come on, get it. Come on and get it.
Look.
What's that? Look. What's
that say, Olay? I don't get no props for admitting that at 20, yes, 23.
Yes. No, yes, you do.
That was sweet.
I want to hear one of your stories now.
Slow clap.
At this age now.
Oh, I'm good. I'm for the past, once I got my 30s, I was on point. I
don't yeah, he it. Just buys popcorn.
I choose quality yeah. now.
It begins when you're 30. I'm telling you right now. Just turn 30. Life begins when you turn 30.
No. It's about quality. And trust me,
quality of life.
A lot of these stories was in my 20s.
What you know about quality? He's like quality.
He's about 15.
Stop
over
there. Exactly.
He's 15 over there on the
yeah,
table.
Yeah, yeah, check this out. See, nobody got heart to call in and ask.
No, everybody's like, mm-mm.
They'll put something in the chat.
Yeah.
We got more from that post, though. From that post, though, right?
Yeah.
That people said. Okay, let's read another one.
Let's see. Flo in the building.
Yes.
Yeah.
Flo is really in the building.
Flo, tell everyone where to follow you.
Yes, please.
Tell everyone where to follow you.
Oh, guys, at FloBGC, that's my Twitter, and also my Instagram, and... If you want to email me your sad stories and broken promises, my email is florinakaya@gmail.com. You know, you're free to spill your heart out over there, you know what I'm saying? And that's about it. And Tuesday nights, don't forget to watch my show. It's at 8 o'clock. It's pretty hot.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And I keep winning because I'm the winner. And Tuesday night, I'll be with the girls at their song release party, the single release party.
Yes, be in the building.
I can't wait. It's going to be fun. Oh,
so that's going to be Tuesday night. Where at?
Yo. Albella.
That's 10 Reed Street.
And I heard
in the city. Yep.
10 Reed Street, Manhattan.
I heard y'all got some surprises at this release party, but
why are you making up stuff?
No, I'm telling you.
Ad living?
Yeah, we got surprises.
No, I did hear.
Come over there. I got a slap across your face, a punch in your mouth.
We got some red flags.
Surprises
for you,
from Flo.
Exactly.
Leave with the bruise. You're welcome.
If you slap me in my face,
he
would
like it.
He would like it. Do it again.
He'll like it.
Men, like, I'm not violent with men at all, but they always want me to be, and I'm like, damn, dude, like, I don't want to be violent. They're like, please. I'm like, but I don't want to hit you. They're like, just be rough with me, and I'm like, but I can't ever be a lady because nobody likes it anymore.
A lady.
So
I can't.
You know the story I want to hear from you, Flo. What made them choose you for Bad Girls Club and say we want Florina to be a part of Bad? What did you do so bad?
Give me 20 minutes alone in the hotel room with you and a camera. And I'll show you why. No, but that's not.
There goes the show.
You totally misunderstood that. That's how they interview for the Bad Girls Club. Okay. In a hotel for 20 minutes.
Wow.
And they just let you go off. And she said, I've never seen somebody like you in my life. I bounced off the walls. I did a booty dance on the wall. I sang for her. I acted. I danced. I did this. I did that. You know, different accents. I was doing everything. She was just like, girl, I don't want to say this, but you're going to be on the show. The second interview I went on, they were like, just pack your shit, you're coming. I was like, okay. That time, you know, like I said it last day in the interview, that at that time the Bad Girls Club was more genuine.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And more authentic.
Yes.
And you know, like I say, I'm the underground rapper of the Bad Girls Club. Shit. And these bitches are all commercial, because today's Bad Girls Club has become like when somebody sells their soul to the devil, mm-hmm, and just does whatever, you know,
right,
what I'm saying,
right, right.
Yeah. Back then it was more fresh and new, and mm-hmm, and they were right, more raw and realistic about it, you know what I'm saying?
The ladies tell me that, and this was last week when you had called in, that you got other talents too. Like I'm hearing that you good with the mic and the studio and all of that. So
I'm you know, the reason why I haven't given you guys something to play tonight, I will next week, you guys can play it, is because it's not mixed yet, right. It's not mastered yet, and okay. I want it to be mastered. Right. I sound good without it being mastered. I sound really good, but I just want it to be mastered. Well, I mean, I have, like, seriously, I could rap for you, but I have a really bad cold right now.
I want you at your best. I don't want.
Yeah, you know, I will spit a few. I'm not shy. I swear to you, if I didn't have the sickest cough right now, I'm not going to pretend. I'm not going to sit here and make myself look like an asshole. Yeah. You know, I'm 100%, homie. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But like I said, I'm not shy. I'm not embarrassed. I'll get up and perform at any time. Like, I went to Bad Girls Club to do the Bad Girls Club, but I also wanted the people to see that when I do my music, my badass image is really who I am. You know what I'm saying? Right, so it'd be perfect. I was like, it's perfect. I go on a show, prove to everybody how tough and how, you know, how strong I am. And then when I rap about it, people will be like, she's not lying. That's really how she is.
Right.
You know, like unlike other artists that come out and they're like, yeah, I'll punch you in the face. Like, who are you? Who are you? Why are you so bad? What makes you so tough? You know what I'm saying? I want to have that authenticity behind what I do.
Right.
So if I have to take me 10 years to put out some songs, I'm going to do it. Mm-hmm. People are going to have to listen to it. And they don't like it too bad, but I'm doing it anyway.
So let me ask you, because I really... I haven't really caught the show like that yet.
Yeah.
Will the Oxygen Channel, the network, let you show your talent some love?
You know what's funny is as I was on it, I was laughing because when I got there, I sang for them, like for the girls. They asked me to sing, and I did a really good job. I did all that, but they never showed it because they just want to show you being a bad girl. Mm-hmm. But this Bad Girls All Star Battle, if they're smart, they'll show when me and Stassi and Erica were in the kitchen and I was like battling them when I was rapping, and I killed it, and they were just like, damn, you got swagger. And they've been rapping for years. I just started rapping. Like, rapping's just something I was like, you know what, I write poems all day, I'll just turn them into raps,
right.
You know, and they're always like those kind of poems that talk about a lot of crazy stuff.
I'll tell you what, before the end of the show, get her some water, me and you gonna battle.
Oh god.
No, we're not, cause I'll destroy you. No, I'm just kidding.
She called me out.
Yes,
he did.
No, I mean, you know, like I said, that's not what I always push and stress, because I'm not the type to be like, listen to me sing, I'm amazing. You know what I'm saying? I want a reality show, and yeah, I represent the Bad Girls Club, but people need to understand that's not what I'm about. I do so many good things with the Bad Girls Club that you would be like, whoa. Go look at my time. Go look at Google me and see how many charity works I've done, right. How many schools I've spoken at, how many kids I've helped, and how much money I've raised, how much money I've given on my own. You know, and then come talk to me.
And that's what I want to talk about.
Yeah.
After the Bad Girls Club, because you know what? Let me tell you, not saying, and again, I don't want to get inboxes like, well, how you going to diss somebody that wants to do reality TV, whatever? Because what I'm about to say is not a diss. But I've met females that have interned here.
Mm-hmm.
And when I asked them what they wanted to do or what they aspired to do, they said, I just want to be on the Bad Girls Club.
A lot of girls say that. And I'm like, no, you don't.
I'm like, no, what else? What else after that? They said, I just want to be on the Bad Girls Club.
Why do you think that?
Because look, like I said, the Bad Girls Club is not supposed to be something you just go on and just go on because you want to make a retard of yourself. Mm-hmm. You go on it because you have a freaking plan with it, man. Right. What are you even going on TV for if you're not planning on doing something with it?
Exactly.
Why? For what reason? That's why they pick people like you to make you look like morons. Mm-hmm. See, there's people like certain people that have that goal and that inspiration to do more than that, so they make sure they don't do certain things on TV, like get belligerently drunk and have sex with half the club in the house like a porno flick. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm just saying, like, you know, if you're gonna do a reality show like the Bad Girls Club, especially put a name like that on yourself, which I didn't even realize all the repercussions I was gonna have to face by having that name behind me. If you're gonna do that, please have a plan. Have a freaking plan, because I'm telling you, if you want to go right back to regular life after that, good luck with that, because ain't nobody going to hire you and no schools are going to accept you.
Right.
So I'm just keeping it real. I'm keeping it funky. Go on there because you have a freaking purpose.
Right.
Not because you want to be an idiot and be like, I fight. Yeah. Woo. Like, we can all fight. Everybody has the fighting instinct in them. We're all killers. Come on, guys. Get over it. You know what I'm saying? We're human. We're humans. If it came down to it, we all know how to defend ourselves.
Right.
God gave us that talent. All of us. But God did not give all of us the talent to go out and perform and use your little bit of celebrity that you get on a little stupid show like the Bad Girls Club and use it for the best things in the world. I'm sorry, but I'm just speaking the truth. Mm-hmm. I could be like, Bad Girls Club is amazing and I love it. Oh my God, I love being a part of that. Oh yeah, but no, that's not what it is. I'm telling you right now. I already been there, done that. Now it's time to make people see, yo, let me use my celebrity for other purposes. If you guys help me, I can be one of God's soldiers. I can be the next ghetto Mother Teresa. Just help me. Help me help you, baby. Help me help you.
Don't
let me go because these other girls that you're in love with, and, oh my God, why'd you say that about her? Like, keep it up because she ain't going to be around for a long time.
But you know what? And that's the B theme of tonight, because if you listen to even like Shariff talk earlier, how he talked about how he used to be, or, you know, how he used to be out there and, you know, the streets doing his thing, and then you can do a complete 360.
And that's what
I want to let everybody know on this show tonight.
Too late to change.
Because if you listen, Shariff, he got his own testimony.
Mm-hmm.
We just heard a great testimony for you, because meeting you would never even think that you want to walk like a Mother Teresa.
No,
you feel me? And this is again about misjudging people.
Wait.
If you did watch the season she was on, you do see that side.
Yes, you do.
Really?
See that side. It took people a little while to see that side, but in the beginning they all hated me, just like this one, just like the Bad Girls All Star Battle. Everybody in the beginning is hating me, but you will all see what the hell I'm trying to do in this world. And you will all see I'm not giving up. And if I have to live the rest of my life serving this world, because if we don't serve this world, the children are our future. People, wake up. Like, we need to help each other. Like, together we can make such a change. And if a person like me can go into a school and make a little bit of a change with girls, young girls, if I could change one thing in a day, I will. Because I know that God wants us here not to just sit around on our lazy asses and not help out. Do something. Put in work. Recycle. Do whatever. Just help somebody. Do some, bro. Throw the blunt wrapper in the garbage instead of on the floor. You know what I'm saying, guys? Get it together. Help each other. I'm not trying to sound all high and mighty, but you know what?
The sad thing about this, and I'm going to keep it 200, is that most people don't want to see positivity.
Nobody wants to see positive. They want to see bad.
So if there was a choice, if there was only two things on network television, if there was Florina doing a great act for a youth and helping the youth out and inspiring them and mentoring them and everything, and there was Jocelyn.
Mm-hmm.
About to curse out Stevie,
Jocelyn.
They would tune into Jocelyn.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, I got something important to say about that. What you just said,
mm-hmm.
I went with the greatest pitch on planet Earth to, I'm not going to say which network, but you know, I went and I was like, look, I want to do Bad Girl Boot Camp with Flo. Girls out there are bad girls. I know, because I've been there and I've done that. And I don't want anybody living that lifestyle. It's dangerous.
Right.
You know, like they say, it's cliche, but you can end up dead or in jail. Mm-hmm. Two things. Or a prostitute or a crackhead on the street, whatever. But the point is, I wanted to go in and reform girls, put them through tests and stuff like that, and have like a boot camp where girls can come in and they think they're there to be bad girls, but really when they get there, like, you're here to change.
Really
put them through real like stuff, like real things where they really learn to change and really learn that that's not the life.
Good
and life will be happy for you if you just do good. People do drugs and stuff like that because we're miserable, you know what I'm saying? That's why the whole world is high on something, you know. Everybody's high on something because everybody's freaking miserable, you know what I'm saying? Like, we wouldn't be so damn miserable if we changed it. Like, we just got to change it together. That's the problem. Stop worrying about Benzes and all that crap. Help each other, like, with other stuff. Like, I could sit here and preach all day about it. But that's my point, is they didn't want the positive.
Right.
They're like, oh, no, because that's going to contradict completely what, you know, some shows are about. And, you know.
That's one of the main reasons why Allure doesn't have a reality show, because when people pitched it to us, they wanted
Oh, they want drama. Allure, fight. Right, no, right, I'm right, sorry right, that right. they're the most amazing group and they lasted till now and they're still doing their thing and they're not fighting.
About that.
Okay. God forbid.
What she just said.
Shut up, Norm. Don't say anything.
Because y'all bring drama to me every week.
it's out of love. No,
yeah, and but it's not like the kind of drama they're talking about.
They want drunk drama.
And your mic is off.
You guys are inspiration to women everywhere, and I would like to involve you guys in the stuff that I do when it comes to the Bad Girls Against Bullying and all that stuff, because young teens need... The celebrities need to get into the schools.
Yeah.
Get into the schools. Worry about America. America's screwed up. I understand you want to help every other country, but go to the schools. Go to America. Our kids are getting shot. They're doing retarded things every day. All we have to do is just go into to schools and help kids. The schools are where you make the changes, because that's where the kids are. Yeah. Go there and talk to them, and they are our future. Help.
And you know what? I'm so glad you said that. And again, three very positive people, and just in the community, just hearing what you're saying right now. Mm-hmm. But I know what Shariff also does during like the holiday times and everything with the kids, the events you give. And could you tell people about that, man? Because
sure,
this is another thing. See, we don't really, me, you really don't kick it a lot, right. But there's a lot of things I respect about you that you do, right. Whatever. And I know we're doing our own thing over here, and we do what we can for our community over here. But
absolutely.
But what you're doing is great too. And this is during the holiday times or throughout the year, you do some things. Could you just tell some of the
absolutely.
People some of the things?
Well, we have I think since 2003 we do an annual book bag drive, where we reach out to all of our parents that support us and patronize us, and say, look, let's book a skating rink, bring all the kids out. But more importantly is let's acknowledge them. Let's give them some encouragement. Let's give them the tools. Mm-hmm. I had a young lady there who actually worked in our organization. She was an intern, and she had this passion to serve the homeless. And we created and supported an organization where we started giving every winter just clothing to the homeless. Mm-hmm. We go in schools and we speak. We do mentorship programs. We've actually working on our own camp as of now to bring young men out to be able to show them just things that they don't get a chance to see. Under positive male role models and individuals that can speak their language, mm-hmm. but at the same time influence them to want to look at other options that are available that mm-hmm. they do not see.
Right.
So what our job is now is to say, let's take whatever success we have, let's package that success, mm-hmm. let's put that success in front of them mm-hmm. so they have another source of inspiration. Why are we the best people to do it? Because we're coming from the road they just came from.
Absolutely. Right.
So
all
we do is show
that's
them.
That's how I feel, exactly.
We show
you
them
have to
that
have
we,
to come from there.
We are you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The difference is the choice and the support.
Right.
So here's the deal.
Right.
Make the choice, we got the support.
Right.
So we're working on something that we're very passionate. Me and Sporty talk about it. This is one of the things that bonded me and him as a brother is not just the events we do. That's this platform.
Right.
That's just business. But at the end of the day, mm-hmm. it was about connecting shared values. It was about connecting common vision.
Absolutely.
It was about connecting and addressing the core issues, which number one, we have a society that is spiritually bankrupt. Let's get that out the way.
Yes.
Then you have what you call failed leadership in a household.
Absolutely.
That's a huge issue. Mm-hmm. So if you want to look at the foundation where we're breaking down, it's not just the man that's missing, it's the leadership that's missing.
Yep.
You got a man in a household and he lacks leadership.
Exactly.
Right, which is accountability. And it's not, listen, at the end of the day, being a young father myself, my son is 17, my daughter is 22, it's not easy.
Right.
Because it's a new dynamic today.
Right.
Oh, yes. You got a new pressure.
Oh, yes.
So mm-hmm. it's very challenging. But at the end of the day, we have a social responsibility to balance out, to do what we can in our community. Like just recently in young organization Sister for Sister that we've been working with for over 14 years.
Wow.
And we work with community partnerships, and we just sponsored a couple of individuals that couldn't afford tuxedos.
Right.
You know what I mean? So we make sure that they can walk at that special day.
Nice.
These are the things that
Those are things that people are not looking at that.
Absolutely.
And they're remember, and it'll make a change.
Right.
But,
absolutely.
But you know what, too, and he's a humble brother. And so I'll say this on his behalf. With something like that, though, they just do it just because they really want to help.
He's not
looking for
not for publicity stunts like some people think people do that for.
No.
Yeah, he's not really trying to get the accolades or whatever like that.
Let me just say this real quickly. You know, you get to a point where there's two dates that's the most important dates of your life. Date one is when you're born,
mm-hmm.
and date two is when you find out why you're born.
Mm-hmm.
When you get to the why you're born, that's a different mission.
Mm-hmm.
So it's bigger, it becomes so bigger than
you know, your little individual desires, mm-hmm. making mm-hmm. money. That's mm-hmm. the small stuff.
Okay. Find out what your purpose is.
Finding out
preach
your purpose.
On, brother. Yep.
But I challenge that. I tell anyone quickly, your purpose is to co-create. God Absolutely. Is the ultimate creator and producer. Yeah, we what, are. Exactly he's the executive producer.
Right.
So we're the co-producer of our that's lives right. and our mm-hmm. world. He's waiting for you to help somebody. The question is, what is your assignment?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Because your purpose is to create, your purpose is to add to humanity, your purpose is talk to make a it. Difference.
And if right. you that's don't have purpose. One, create one for yourself.
So it's just, so I use this analogy all the time. It's just like if you signed up for the fire department,
mm-hmm.
you're cleared to fight the fire. You're clear mm-hmm. why you're there. You're right. just waiting right. for the damn fire in the
right.
house
right.
so you know where
right.
to go.
Exactly.
So that's the real question that I ask myself. It, you know, it's not what I want to do, but what is my God-given destiny?
Yes.
Let me get
that's
that
right.
answer. Because if I can get there, then I got least resistance.
Right. right.
Because I'm going in a path where whatever's in front of me, it doesn't matter because right. God said go north.
Right.
So
absolutely.
I'm going north. It doesn't Amen. Matter what's in front of me because mm-hmm. this is divine plan versus what I decided I want to do.
Right. Exactly.
And, you know, and that's a challenge because we got our little things we want to experience.
Right. Right.
But it's the big question. So I try my best in my work
right.
to be able to allow whatever accomplishments we do as a team, because trust me, without my team, mm-hmm. it just I can't do nothing.
Mm-hmm. No doubt.
You know, I'm mm-hmm. good by myself,
no
but
doubt.
I'm great with the team.
No yes. doubt.
But exactly. to use those But to use
I
those,
can't find
yeah,
can't find a team for the death of me because I'm too loyal and nobody
me,
could
let me,
ever
let me,
ever.
Let me tell you, I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna tell you right now. Everything happens for a reason.
Mm-hmm. No doubt.
And a quick mushy moment. Nah. This is the best team that I found
oh,
in the minute.
It's a blessing.
It's a blessing. To do a show.
God bless
with,
you. You're very
and,
lucky.
And shout out.
I'm very jealous. I hate you.
But I love you though. Bro. You know what I'm saying? But no, this is the best team because one, not only are they talented,
right.
And beautiful, they're compassionate and they genuinely care about people.
Yes, we do.
You know, and I just watched them, and even when they had organizational, I got it right this time, the Blossom Sisters.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And they do things in the community to help out the youth through dance.
Right,
right, right. right.
And give them affordable dance
right.
lessons and all of that, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. And I just watching the involvement and how they tear up talking about it. And well, they're serious about helping people,
right.
you know? And we joke around and we play around a lot like
yeah.
that, but I could see we together yeah. as right. a team, as a unit, we're going to do great things together. Mm-hmm. We got each other's back on this show.
Yeah,
yeah.
we do.
Aw,
yeah. teach you.
And,
you don't and, have to wear a mask anymore.
Yeah.
Aww.
You can wear your you cap. Can but honestly, I think, I mean, I know
no,
you
no.
can,
no, no, ahead,
you can kind of like, come,
oh,
yeah,
Trey,
where
I love
from.
You.
yes,
that
thank
just
you,
comes
Trey.
From, like you said, you know, you became a father. And once you become a mother, like we become mothers or whatever the case is, even through all our mistakes and you trying to figure out, you know, what I'm doing, even at 36 years, sometimes we're like, we're still learning.
Absolutely.
But when you have a child and you know what you want for your child,
that's
yes.
right.
it just gives you that passion to care about somebody else.
That's very
there's
true.
A lot of parents out here who don't
gives
care
it a
about
drive
their kids.
That you change right. for you, them.
Yeah,
I did.
Because there's parents that they have their kids and just,
right.
you know, it's whatever. Let them out to the wolves
like,
and
what
whatever happens.
Yeah,
happens.
It's like,
right.
why are you having
I
kids
don't
for?
Get that.
Stop now.
But,
please stop,
but,
please.
But,
stop now.
But,
please stop having kids if you don't want to.
And I know.
And it just makes you want to help people.
We just got deep and serious here.
No, we got deep and serious.
Yeah, we forgot about the topic.
But we're going to go back to top, but sometimes you got to do this.
Sometimes you got to teach. When
yeah.
it calls
yeah.
to say
oh, yeah.
something,
nah,
you gotta
that,
say
that,
exactly.
That's well-needed information.
Right.
Yes.
Now.
Oh yeah.
I got to tell y'all this. There's a situation that happened with the station, and this happened about I think it was about a year ago, whereas somebody that's popular in the boxing game recommended and say, you know, you guys should have a DJ show for the youth. So, on his word, and because he's fam, and if you're listening, bro, you know I love you. Still got love for you and everything. He recommended these kids, and they came in and did their DJ show. And we didn't charge them or anything, which, you know, somebody comes to do a show at BKS when mm-hmm. we use the internet, whatever, like that. We charge you for the operating time and all mm-hmm. that, whatever. So we said, okay, we're going to produce, we're running, let the kids do what they do their little DJ thing, whatever. So the kids didn't take it that seriously. You know, we tried to teach them professionalism or whatever like that. And, you know, but we still hung in there and stuck with it. So they started missing days and whatever. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Found out. not going to use names, and I know we got people that's listening that probably know the situation. One of the kids, two of the kids, got locked up for armed robbery.
Wow.
In certain situations. Mm-hmm. So the person that was in charge of them, the young lady that was in charge of them, reached out to me like months later. And I'm not going to lie to you. It left a bitter taste in my mouth about people recommending certain youth and whatever. Mm-hmm. So it left a bitter taste in the team's mouth. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, oh, man, I want to help kids.
Right, right.
But after
right.
this situation.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a new day.
Yeah, I got to look at things different.
Absolutely.
Because I had these cats in my spot.
Right, mm-hmm. right.
So for a minute, I wasn't going to do no more internships for a while. I was going to do this. That left a bad taste because this was a very publicized incident. Mm. It was all over the news. So I was like, and then people related it back here.
Exactly. Yeah. Right.
You feel me? Yep. Like, okay, what wasn't they? Didn't they have a show on?
Right.
Such. And I was like, oh, Jesus. So I got a call and it's like, Norm, well, the same team, they want to come back in. You know, and a few of the guys that were down with him that didn't get, that they reorganized itself and they trying to do it again, whatever like that. So I'm going to be honest. And I said, well, let me talk to my team. But right now, I just don't think that's a good thing. Mm-hmm. I'm falling back from the intern thing. We got our crew. We good. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we get emails and inboxes from brothers like him and whatever like that. We responded back. Mm-hmm. We brought him in. I said, this time I'm going to audition and vet myself.
Gotcha.
I'm going to go through a vetting process.
Absolutely.
Because I didn't want people to think that now because a couple of youths messed up,
right.
Now I'm down on all of them.
Right.
And
that wouldn't
not
be fair.
Yeah, no, and I'm not going to give nobody a shot.
Right.
Whatever. So when this brother hit me up, yo, you know, let me, I want to intern, and college credits and this and that, whatever like that. I realized everybody's not the same.
Exactly.
That's true.
Some people do want an opportunity to make the best of it.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? So this young brother right here, this is the best, one of the best interns that walked through the Cast One Radio.
Yeah, we love him. Thank you.
Steven Young. Good dude. Loyal. Down to earth. Mm-hmm. He rocks out.
Hungry. Mm-hmm.
Don't complain. Wants to learn more.
Yes.
And that drives me. That inspires me. Mm-hmm. You know. And I've been blessed with a lot of different talents, from engineering to this to studio to whatever. I'm gonna show what I know. I'm gonna show this young man.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know. So you can't get discouraged. And I say all that to say you can't get discouraged because there are certain situations that go on in our community.
There are some bad apples.
Whatever that will make you be like, I just want to stay away from the youth period because I don't trust them. You can't get discouraged.
I just want to say one thing that's sticking in my mind. Just remember, everybody out there, there's enough room for all of us to make it in this world. So please stop thinking that you have to push everybody out the way to make it on top. Mm-hmm. Certain scenarios, you know, you have to be the boss, whatever. But, you know, most of the things in life, especially with music and stuff like that, people are never going to stop listening to music. They're never going to stop watching shows. They're never, you know, just help each other. Stop being so greedy and selfish. Like, stop being greedy. Help each other. Stop being greedy. Help each other.
That's the next song.
Yeah. For real, stop being greedy. Help each other. Stop being greedy. Help each other. Help each other.
But you know what, Steve? You got some music right there, man. Run a song real quick. We're gonna
take a
quick.
What kind of music I'm gonna do? I don't care if people are like, she's corny.
4 minute break.
I'm doing positive stuff. And
and we're gonna come right back because I gotta still, like, right now, while we got Shariff in the building, I wanna talk more about that event, man, because a lot of people been in my ear about it. Like, yo, it's 3 days, son. AC, son.
Oh, I'm going to be there. Oh, you better believe I'm going to be there. I love that.
Did you bring
what?
Some? You brought some flyers?
Yeah, we go. You know. Driver's license.
Yeah.
We pull that out before the license.
Yeah. So run, find a song. Matter of fact, go on the search. You see the search up there?
Yes, good
R&B. No, fine. Yeah, fine. Put in butterflies. I want to hear this song. These girls I like. One of them really gets on my nerves, but still play the song anyway. I think the song is called Butterflies. Just put in butterflies. You'll see. What's the girl group? Allure.
You are so funny.
Allure.
corn dog.
Ain't that their new song too?
Yes, and yeah. we thank everybody for all the love and support. We had to bring it back because for a second there we were like, no, thank you.
You see it?
But everybody started showing us love, so we appreciate it and thank you.
And we have to remind you guys real quick in celebration of the fact that we are back and we have our new single, Butterflies. June 11th, we're going to be at Albella 10 Reed Street in Manhattan celebrating our single release party. Free admission, so you ain't got to say, I don't have the money for it.
Don't worry, you ain't got to be there before 12. You ain't got to ask no guys to get you in. You can save that $20 for a drink.
Exactly. Do it. And you got from 5 to 12 to get there. We go on at 8 o'clock. When I say 8 o'clock, 8
p.m. sharp. And your girl Florina is going to be in the
VIP.
How I get the party started.
So, let's ask Shariff how we rolling on that day. We rolling up to the spot AC VIP. We rolling VIP.
There's no question.
All right.
That'd be disrespectful.
My girl singing something.
We told we can make that happen. They want to sing, they can sing.
But
let's
look,
do it.
But first of all, all right. And again,
I think we set the
why
stage.
Why are you always
trying
to get us
stage?
To work? Sometimes we want to enjoy. Yeah. Enjoy. Can we enjoy the ambiance?
No,
we don't
get
to enjoy things
we,
often.
We really don't.
Nobody needs a check. I forgot. I'm sorry. I'll shut up.
Oh, shut up. Oh, whatever.
But look, last night, they was at the event. And shout out to Shariff, too, because he was in the movie last night. Usman Shariff's Criminal Behavior.
Yes.
And he had a part in the movie last night. And the girls came in and... was doing a step and repeat, the red carpet and everything. We did the interview on there, and they sung All Cried Out. And it's funny because one of the girls, I wasn't even suggesting nothing, and she was like, All Cried Out. You remember the girl that said that? She's like, see?
She said Head Over Heels.
Head Over Heels?
That sounds whack without the track.
Right. It's like, okay.
But you know what? All Cried Out, like, just when y'all don't even do the whole thing.
No.
And y'all jump right on a harmony. If y'all singing that Shariff's thing on in the AC, just give them a little sample.
I will throw my panties on stage.
I would throw my balloons on stage.
Don't worry, there'll be panties with tags on them.
Have you seen his underwear? Where's your underwear?
No. Tiny Tim.
Let me see what you got. You be wearing them interesting underwear?
No, check this out.
No.
Please do
no.
not listen to them right now.
I know a lot of guys that wear like funny underwear. Like
His hilarious.
Yeah.
He has so much laughter.
So it's not the kind of like humor funny. It's like ridiculous.
Can we give him a sample? Yeah.
Like what?
Of what y'all going to do?
Tiny Whitey said.
No, I will talk to
penis
you later.
Penis all in the bulge like this, in the middle like this. It's all just poking out. It looks like it's going to attack you and whatnot.
Norm's bedroom always sounds like a comedy show.
There you go.
Yo, me too. I be laughing while I have sex too. So welcome to my club.
And it reeks of yellow rice and chuletas.
Yellow rice and beans. Huh?
Did you just say that?
I'll be toying you.
I can't wait to our second date.
Goya, what's, oh boy.
And we're going to film
what's
it too.
Going on?
He always.
We're going to film the second date.
He took pictures and everything. Wow.
What's your sign? What's your sign?
Anyway.
Storm.
Huh?
What's your sign?
I'm Aquarius.
Oh,
did you hear that?
I'm Aquarius.
I'll tell you why.
My name is Noah.
An Aquarius, man. They are freaks. They'll try anything. Like, that's like a, you have to add the singing into that one because they will do anything. You know, Aquarius men are very adventurous, but they're very intellectual, deep thinkers, and
Absolutely. They're
weird. They're kind of weird, but
yeah,
it's cool.
Yeah.
You know?
Not weird.
They're big weirdos. Like, they're really weird. You have to learn and accept their personalities in order to be around them.
We had to learn to accept.
I mean, what's your signs? What's your signs, the girls? What's your signs?
Virgo.
I'm a Virgo.
Wait, when?
September 1st.
All right.
What are you? What are you?
I am September
1st. Oh, you're a control freak.
21st.
Oh, control
and you're Leo?
Yes.
So you're good. You're with the Virgo.
Oh,
we think alike. We get along because our egos are like, we could easily be like, okay, you're
that's
cool.
That's my
you're
mom, too.
We're good.
Of course.
What's your my mom's is October October 19th.
Yeah. Oh, mine goes October 16th.
Yeah. That's my mom, October
19th. Libra,
yeah.
Right?
Okay.
Me and my
Libra.
Mom, get along. I love my mom.
Libra,
that's why I like you.
Yeah, me and my mom.
Cancer.
Always
I love that. What's your sign?
Nice.
I'm a Cancer.
And believe it or not,
me and Lieberman.
I'm the only Leo.
Keith is actually my love song.
All right, I can hold actually, it down.
You are. Oh, God. Keith, you know you love me. Stop
so
playing.
We heard. So we heard.
Whatever. So whatever.
Could we get back to the
just make me some rice.
Something.
Anyway.
The other Puerto Rican must have been a Scorpio.
I can't.
Scorpion.
So, we're going to give you a little sample of
what
with
we
the girls.
What?
I just want to get, I love all cried out. Get busted with me?
You're going to have to start giving us a
yeah, it's like,
because you got concerts.
June 11th, hello. Come hear us sing that song.
Anyway, they're going to give you a sample.
We're going to do it for Flow, because we,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, that's our favorite.
Oh, you guys are
yeah.
Yeah.
That
was when she started no. going outside.
Dude, they're like, Flo, you know, we know you. We know
and
you love you.
And I'm
like, laughing. I went in the car, girl. I went in the car. I was like, oh, my God. I just met a lot. Ah! Like a serious groupie. And then my friend's like, calm down. I was like, I didn't do that in front of them. So I had to do it. I had to let it go. She was like, all right. So I was like, I let it go in the car, though. She was like, good job. I was like, good job.
What's funny is we did that to her. We was like, we love you. You're our favorite.
Like, she's like, we love, they're like, we love you, our favorite banger. I'm laughing. I'm in my head. I'm like, are they serious right now? That's like when Method Man and all them came up to me. We were like, we're big fans. For I was like.
Yo, shout out to the chat room right now. Chat room. Yeah, Corlin, I know y'all in the chat going in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I think people are afraid to tell
sexting?
Their worst date.
I
yeah.
So.
Yeah. Anybody sexting on that chat room already?
Sexting, right?
Are they already hooking up? They're like, yo, forget the radio show. Where you at?
Yo, that's it.
Call me.
Now check this out. Come on, girls.
What?
What?
Give it to the
world. We were trying to go somewhere else with that.
No?
No. Oh. Give it to the world.
Okay.
About 9 million times.
Right.
Count you. Count
ready?
Five, six.
Don't you know my tears will cause an inferno? Romance often fades. Why should I take the blame? You are the one who left me neglected. But the traffic was so noisy that you could not hear me cry. Yeah, yeah.
Now come to the show.
Now come to the show. You'll hear more.
Oh, God, that was amazing.
Amazing. Oh, thank perfection.
Tell me you got that single, man.
Thank you.
Butterfly.
Perfecciones.
Right,
you don't even know what it feels like to be here and hear that. You are so jealous.
BKS1Radio.com.
You hate me.
Brand new single, Allure. It's called Butterflies.
Yes.
And what I love about this, because if you know anything about good music, it takes you back to the 90s with a touch of 2013.
That's what I'm talking about.
This is why I love it.
We did that. We did that.
Okay, we'll be nice to you for the next half hour.
Yeah.
That's not, what? That's not it.
Aaliyah, rest in peace, but you know.
I forgot he's young. Man, if you don't find that butterflies after that introduction.
You got us all growing you hard
it.
Body.
He got it.
No,
everybody,
like,
yo,
we
have to.
I'm going to have to get
the laser beam on
us.
He said laser beam.
The laser beam.
Yo, shout out to everybody right now that's on BKSOnRadio.com.
Yes.
The Grown.
Sexy Situation.
Every Thursday night, 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Big shout out to the ladies of Al will be on tonight.
Yeah, because
tonight. Yes, 11 p.m. All female show, BKSOnRadio.com. Yes. To all ladies, Trey K., Ms. Hayes, Drama Free C., Miss Lee. I'm missing somebody.
The
governess.
Right.
Get it together.
Right.
Get it
together. You don't know that name. We tell
you. She got the enforcer.
You got.
Only women wear high heels. What they be saying?
She is
yes.
Running Man, Butterflies. New joint by Lua.
Butterfly.
out to everybody in the chat room. Shout out to our guests.
Yes, I know. I'm giving you every part of me, not just my heart and soul. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Running towards the feelings that replay in my head.
Shariff don't remember this. She was a young man.
Yeah,
man. This is Allure, no question, with LL. Poetry in motion, but the heart regulates the devotion. Love is floating in the sky blue ocean. Think about it, feel emotion. Young queen, it reminds me of a smooth down movie scene. Two bodies intertwined on the screen. Everybody make love in their dreams, but this is real. Not me, not me. Passion is the way of the world. Electricity when boy meets girl. And making love is the key. A burning flame that'll last eternally.
You should know that I'm here for you. As long as you see me through, I would give all I have just to be with you. Don't you see, honey, it could be.
Yeah.
Shout out to our super intern Steve on the ones and twos.
Great job.
We are back. We are back. We sitting here kicking it, having it, having some good conversation.
Yes.
Shout out to Steve.
About the past and everything. And some crazy dates. Now who didn't we get to about these the worst dates ever?
Mr. E.
No. How about La? Let's go write the La.
Oh.
Your worst date ever, or the one thing that just turns you off when you're on the first date.
Well,
if a guy say or do something, what's that one thing that would turn you off?
Yeah.
All right. Actually, there were two. But I'll give you the short version because
we want the version.
No.
The good thing about this, y'all do this show with the CEO, so we can go over time. Go ahead.
Hilarious. We got clout. All right. The first one I remember, I was about 16, maybe 16 and a half. That's when my mother let me start dating. And I went out with the guy. He was cute. He had a goatee. He had his little swag going on. So I'm like, okay.
Excuse me 1 second. I'm sorry. I got to apologize. I'm sorry. I did not have the phone line signed in.
You did it?
Are you kidding?
Yes, we missed up. I do a lot. Come on. I'm sorry. Forgive me.
Oh, we're sorry, callers.
I'm assigning right now, listening.
See, they had stories, and I wouldn't have had to.
You had us all sad. Like, yeah. Nobody cares about these stories.
Call. What that say?
Please.
Did that happen last week?
Yeah, he's not signed in.
Did that happen last week?
No.
No, we had callers last week.
No.
You messed up.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I'm signing in right now while she's telling the story. I'm sorry.
All right. Okay. So, team. So he would wear his fitteds. Well, I think it was snapbacks then. But anyway, so he was really cute, really cute. Got on a date, fine, go to the restaurant. And he took his hat off, and he was follicularly challenged. Now, I say that to say, when he took the hat off, he kind of resembled
Sherman Hemsley.
That's Mr. Jefferson. And he was like 17 and 3/4. And I was kind of perplexed. Like, I was looking like, maybe you should take the goatee hair and put it in right there. And then maybe, but I didn't go back out with
First
him.
First of all, I'm mad because you said follicularly challenged.
Why was he 17 already balding?
What happens. It's genetic sometimes.
I know.
I love every bald guy out there. Please keep listening. But
shave it all off.
Yes.
Okay.
Add it back on. Do something.
Right.
And again, forgive
me. It happens. It even happens to us women, but we can hide it well.
I just turned the phone lines on. Forgive me. I'm sorry. People have been trying to call me like crazy.
That's disgusting.
Call it from the 209. State your name where you're calling from. You're on the grown.
Sexy situation.
What's good? I'm sorry.
Call Hello?
It. Yes. You're live on the air.
Yeah, is Flo still on?
Flo is right here.
I'm here.
Hello? Hey, yo, hold on, my baby mama want to speak to you. Here.
Oh.
Oh, what in the...
Hold on. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
What's going on, girl?
Do we have to say like a worst date story, or can I just say anything?
What's that? Say that again.
Okay. Do I have to say the worst date story, or can I just say anything?
What? Oh, you could. If you want to tell a date story, that would be great. Tell us your date story. You know, don't make it a long story, but tell us your date story. We want to hear it.
I can't hear.
You could say whatever you want. Just say whatever you want. If you called, did you call to ask me something, or you just want
to
say something?
Yeah, if you called to speak to Flo, ask her your questions.
Yeah,
sweetie.
Definitely.
Before you get the do.
Hello.
You are the most. Hello.
Yes, we can hear you. We can hear you.
Yeah. You are the most baddest girl on Bad Girls Club. Thank oh my you. God, you Thank are like the baddest girl of all of them, and the realest.
Thank you.
Oh my God, you're Thank so you. Pretty.
Girl, you want me to come over there and hook up with you and your baby daddy, girl?
That's another topic.
Take you both on right now.
I think her phone.
She just hung up. Yeah.
No, her phone. Them? She must have lost the signal.
She
just hung up. But check this out. Call us. Do me a favor, Steve, please go in the chat and tell people they can call in now.
Yes.
We'll stay on a little extra, whatever.
No one made a boo-boo.
Yeah, no, but I meant to it. I forgot to sign into the call center.
We're sorry, callers.
I forgot to sign into the call center. I'm
646-233-1302. Call in.
Yeah, call in. My bad.
All right, so the second story was, back to me. All right, there was a guy. He was really nice, but he was an undercover wife beater. So... It wasn't even really a date. I went to the house, chilling, watching TV, whatever. Chips, cool. Young again. Anyway, cool. His mother's there. We're in the living room. So we're playing around, like, you know, roughhousing or whatever. So he hits me a little bit too hard. So I'm like, okay, I'm going to hit you back. So he hits me way too hard. And I'm like,
flying
okay.
Flying across the room and against the wall.
Not really. But so we go, I say, you know, I respect your mom. Your mama's here. Let's go in the hallway. Shoot a fair one, whatever. So we go in the hallway.
Shoot a fair one.
Wait, so I picked up my pocketbook. It was mad shiny because that was when patent leather was hot. So I picked it up and I put it outside the door. So before he could get across the threshold, because I'm lightweight, I was like, blah, blah, blah. And then I took my bag and left.
She's a thug.
I didn't knock him out. I just got a couple bars.
She got a couple of them.
First of all, I would say y'all gonna be mad.
No, because you don't. I don't know what kind of girls he used to mess with, but that wasn't me.
Maybe you taught him a lesson. That's all women should not be beat on.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I was talking to my peoples today about the ladies of Allure, right? So, you know, it was kind of asking questions like, who's this one? Who's this type of one? Whatever, right? Who's the hood one? They said, who's the hood one? You know, I said, lie. I said, she got this walk. She do, right?
It's yours.
Huh? Yeah, it's your walk.
You imitating me?
Yes.
When you do that?
That was your fake imitation.
Could you do that walk for the listeners?
No.
Please.
That's our listeners. But no, I used to be a tomboy. So it's like within.
Yo, but I was like, I said, out of the crew, I said, they all got a little, if they had to get with you, they got a little bit of that in them. I said,
one of these days when we have the right, correct topic, we'll put you on Ask the Police.
Yeah. Right. When we have the right topic.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. So what the topic got to be
We're
about?
Not going to tell We're you.
We won't think about that.
You got to guess.
All right. But all no right. doubt. But it's a lie, though.
So no, okay, it's not. That's the Bronx in me. I just had to defend myself.
All right, but it's you though.
No,
because you know
this one got pinned as the bougie
one.
What? It wasn't by me.
Who said that about me?
This one is the bougie
see?
One.
See, that's when Brooklyn comes out. See,
you gotta start her up. Why you tell that?
And somebody just got her told.
Well, hold on.
I ain't gonna tell you what they said.
One second.
You.
If you notice, wait a minute. If you notice, who has their purse next to them? Look that way. What? Because she always got something.
Wait. You said somebody got me totally wrong. What they say about me? I'm interested.
It was just totally wrong.
What?
You really want to know?
Mine was.
Hello. Hers was wrong. Bougie?
Yeah,
really?
that.
None of us are bougie.
Call it. Matter of fact, come here.
No. They said you were the sweet one.
Oh, you know what? Kiss my butt. Whatever.
No,
we
really.
All sweet.
Yo, who got something to say about Allure?
Exactly.
Come see me, homie.
Playing.
Yeah. Come see me.
Yeah.
Stand down, New York. Come to Victory Boulevard and Zebra Avenue. I'll be waiting for you.
Wait.
Yo, come through. I got the Vaseline. I don't got nails
you
on.
Do flow
none
pose.
Of that. Come through, bitch.
Can I do a contest?
Come through, bitch.
This is a new contest on the Grown Sexy Situation. If you want to get knocked out by Flo,
say something bad about
her. Say something
bad. Yo, don't do it. For real, don't do it. For real, yo, don't make me get the all bangs.
Listen, I love you to death, and I'm scared. So
don't mess with Allure because I will karate chop you in the balls or in the boobie. I will punch you in the titty so hard, you will be hurting for a month.
I felt that.
Now the bad girl came out.
No, seriously.
I'll give you a purple nipple, Indian burn, all that good shit.
No, seriously. They said I was bougie?
That's just their opinion.
Tell him to call.
Well,
him.
Your opinion sucks.
No, I mean, hey, if that's the okay, I'll take.
You have the wrong opinion and the wrong. It's not an opinion. It's a judgment, sweetheart.
I
can't make an opinion on somebody you don't know.
And other person said. She's the sweet one. She's real nice. I said, what?
What's so hood? Because I didn't want to get beat. What's so hood about that?
They just going off of what they think.
That was before this story.
Right, so what did I...
You was prejudging.
Yeah. Prejudice.
Yo, listen, man. Shut your mouth. You don't know what you're talking about.
But what's wrong with it, though? If that's what they
really think. No, I said, I'm hood. And
I'm just, that's a... That just means she has class, so and? What is it? She has cool.
Yeah, but... any, but... Let's
okay,
go
so we're gonna
now.
Pass all the judgmental stuff and go back to our topic.
Can we go to Aaliyah? No, I'm not gonna go back to Aaliyah.
What?
So Aaliyah, what's your worst date story?
Okay.
Your bad date story.
I had a lot of nice dates. Right. Because you know.
Wait, that had to be one.
It wasn't horrible. I mean, it was disgusting. I mean, we got a call. We got a call on my. Thank you. Thank you, 504.
What's
going on about that ring?
Call, yeah. Call it from the 5. That's because I had to re-sign it again. Call it from the 504. State your name when you're calling from. You're on the grown.
Sexy situation.
What's good?
What's up, y'all? This is Leon from New Orleans.
Hi, Leon.
What's up, fam? What's good, son?
Dirty.
Good. What's happening? I'm calling talking to Big Flo. What's going on?
What up, big homie?
I love it.
How you living?
I'm living good. How about you, boo?
Oh, I'm doing well. I enjoyed this past episode at All Stars.
Thank you, babe. Do you like it? I kind of killed it, right?
Yeah. You definitely came out of the business like you did on that season.
You know, when I walked in that house, I knew already what time it was. We got all these girls against me, ready. Already looking at me like, she's the devil, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, yo, I got to do what I got to do, but thank you, I appreciate it.
Right.
You sound like a nice
girl. I'm bad for putting you on that situation like that.
Thank you. You sound like you're real thugged out, too. That's what you see. I'm saying all the sexy thugs be loving some flow, boo.
Oh, okay. You making me blush, bro. You making me blush. Got to do other things for you.
I made you blush? Oh, boy. I want to see that.
So right now, big homie, get on the Twitter right now. Yes. And let the world know you just spoke to Flo.
I love you, baby. Thank you for calling me.
If they want to call in, give them the number and tell them you can watch her live right now, BKS1Radio.com.
Yes. Tell them that, boo. I love you.
Good. I love you too, Flo. Thanks for following me on Twitter last week. No,
anytime. That's how I do.
Me on Twitter.
I love you. Bye.
Love you too. Later.
Yo, peace out, big homie.
New Orleans.
Appreciate it.
No doubt. All right, callers. The lines is now open again. Forgive me for not having that call center signed in. But on the lines is now open. We got Shariff James in the building. Mission
yes.
Entertainment.
Yes.
Sporty in the building.
Yes.
Man, I want to hear about you. What you didn't talk about? Talk about your gospel movements that you're making, man. What you doing with the whole gospel thing, real quick? Thank you. We need to hear about that.
I'm just trying to figure out. Got two groups going: Highlight Juniors, Carol and Anointing Stevens Singers.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. All right, listen. We got a big show coming up in JPAT. Tamla Manns.
Oh, that's great.
Mr. Brown.
We love her. Yes. We love them.
Yes.
The lady is awesome. A lot of power. A lot of energy.
Yes, she is.
It's going to be real big. September 13th. Come on down to NJ Pack. Enjoy to Mission Entertainment. We're going to do it real big.
Nice.
That's great.
Bring your tissue.
Oh yeah.
Bring your tissue because
you had me crying in the car.
You gotta get the album.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Get the album, listen to number 12. Number 12 make you cry.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Number 12 is real strong.
Thank you, Sporty.
The blood.
Okay.
They looking at me like
enough said.
They looking at me like I'm about to cry over here, but
no. I was thinking of the king, the
Take me to the king.
That's
what
I
was thinking.
Great song, number 12, Touch Your Heart.
I'm Muslim, but I love gospel music. Sorry, Allah.
No, I...
Wait.
I can't.
Flow
is
flow. Oh, my God, I want to wrestle you right now. I got to chase sometimes, too. Because I like it. I like going to get the bread and all that stuff. And I'll be wanting mad money in the basket. They'll be like, what are you doing, girl? That goes to the preacher. He's buying a Benz with that. I'm like... They say that about Muslims.
She said,
That was not a Muslim who said that. Not like the bread, you know?
I'm suing
Jesus' body. Yo, guys, I'm not making fun of it at all. See what I'm saying? This is where people take shit crazy. I'm saying I'm a huge supporter of every religion. I'm Muslim, right. But I'm a supporter of every religion. I like every type of anything that's inspirational. Right. I'll be watching that inspirational channel in the morning. I'm not Christian, but you'd be like, you know, God loves you. And I'm like, he does love me. That's right. You know what I'm saying? So, yo, you know, keep it gangster.
And that was Flo. Back to you, Bob.
Awkward.
Awkward.
Yeah, but on the real,
oh, I love it.
On Sundays, I want everybody to listen to BKS1.
Yes.
They got a gospel program coming that's going to be out this world.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So, all y'all down south, you know Doc McKenzie. Mm. If you know Darrell, Dow McFadden. You know Lee Williams, BKS1 got you.
Nice.
They're gonna bring you the best. Look out for the Highlight Juniors. Look out for Carol. And look out for Tamla Mann. So this is going down September 13th.
Nice.
Get your tickets early.
No doubt.
We're going to put them out early because it's going to be a sold out concert.
Yeah, we'll definitely do the coverage on that too, man.
Yeah. BKS1 is the way
to go. Would you guys ever do a gospel track, Allure?
Yes. Every album.
Okay. It's funny because off camera, I was just asking, wasn't I asking you that?
Mm-hmm.
About the whole gospel. I was kind of shocked, though. She's like, no, we do gospel too. I was like,
yeah, we grew up in church. We sing Sundays.
Yeah, I figured.
Still in the choir.
That demon.
Oh, this demon. Oh, let's not go there. This demon.
We love Jesus.
Yeah, no, hey, but on a real, look out for
Did you? No, you just turned it.
Yeah.
Look out for missionentertainment.com. Go there. You can check it out. You can go to Sporty's Gospel on Facebook.
Nice.
Or you can go to Sporty D on Facebook. If you want to check some groups out, you can check it out. Cool. But always tune in to mission-entertainment.com, where we bring you the best entertainment live and the best parties live.
Nice. Very nice.
Let them know what's happening.
Please.
This is for the record. It's his actually birthday in Atlantic City, the Saturday of the White.
Okay. Yeah,
that's Sporty's birthday, so we're going in a little extra.
Right.
Yeah, shout out to the Bengal boys. So let's give it up for Sporty. Early birthday.
Yay. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Sporty.
Shout out to BKS1.
Oh, yeah.
Can we do it live? Can you come down there live?
Absolutely. We could actually broadcast.
Cool. Let's do that.
Live. They're trying. Yeah. Yeah.
Let's do that.
Bro. Hey, look.
It's the logistics we got to work out, right?
Nah, but let me tell you right now. I'm going to tell you right now why I love what you're doing, what we're doing. They just asked us to come out to Trinidad and broadcast live.
Wow. That's great.
Yes,
nice.
We are doing the Trinidad event.
That's great.
Cool.
Yes. Yes. So we'll talk about the logistics and we'll get it popping.
Okay.
Yes.
Take me with you, Norm.
You gotta bring Steve.
Yeah, real talk, we're doing a major Trinidad event, BKS at a stadium out there.
That's great.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Good job, BKS.
Yes.
Woo.
For real.
Shout out to the Trinidadians.
We love them.
And shout out to Allure again. Y'all make sure y'all come out. We said June 11th.
Yes.
Take that serious.
Oh, yeah.
They got to take that serious.
Yes.
Yeah, they need to go ahead and pay attention.
Matter of fact, Allure Live 2 on Facebook, on Twitter.
On Twitter, Allure World. Follow our Instagram, Allure World, and also our YouTube, Official Allure.
Yeah. And when I say Allure Live 2, it's Allure Live
T-O-O. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Right.
Now, look, I'm coming to that for a few reasons, and shout out to my girl E, because we was talking about the event yesterday. One, because Mission Entertainment's events are always off the hook.
Mm-hmm.
That's one reason. Two, now I know my girls is going to get a chance to promote their new joint, which is hot. We just heard it.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? And that's another reason. But three, just to support great, good positive events, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And the fact that I just bought an all white hat. I gotta come.
Oh my God. Just made me an all white dress. Isn't that ironic?
Yeah.
Don't you think?
So no, let me say something real quick. You know, this for you, Norm.
What's up, fam?
Nah, I gotta say, man, I just we appreciate you from saying yes to your vision and continue to create it. This is what you call a good platform. Mm-hmm. You know, positive energy, a diverse programming mm-hmm. with music, entertainment, mm-hmm. information. Mm-hmm. It's important. This is not easy to do. Mm-hmm. Costs money to do it. Mm-hmm. And believe me, anytime you persevere for a while, that comes with ups and downs, peaks yeah. and valleys. Yeah. So I want to give it up to you from just holding on, brother.
Aww, and, we love you.
You know, if you would have said, listen to this, right? If you would have said no earlier, they wouldn't be here. So you keep going. Yep. It allows them to be here and more opportunities. This gentleman here, yeah. Flo doing her yes. thing, all this positive energy. Right. I think it's a great
very
evening.
Very positive, amazing energy.
They're getting a balance of everything right now, new mm-hmm. stuff coming up. So, brother, you know, kudos to you, man, and the yes. team. And just hold that vision, brother. It's going to get bigger and better.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Yay. All right.
Appreciate you.
You gonna cry?
Yeah,
we appreciate you.
You gave
us a cry?
Yeah.
What?
No, because when you think of your struggle, everyone has a
yeah,
story.
Yeah, absolutely.
Everyone has a story because not for nothing, we got discouraged at one point right. in time and we
a
had to
times.
Help each other. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Right.
But when God gives you yeah. something, he has something for you.
Who can take that's it right. away. That's right. That's right.
And I don't
right.
care
everybody
which God
that.
You believe in.
Right. That's what I was going to say. It doesn't matter who you believe in. Sometimes you get discouraged. But, y'all, I'm telling you, if you keep believing in yourself, trust me, if you keep believing in yourself, you will get absolutely. To where you want to be in life. Yeah. Trust
and
me.
And let me just add to that. This is what I believe. 80% of your success is really directly who your inner circle is.
Right. Yeah.
That's you very true. You are who you hang with. You are who you hang with.
You can have all the education in the world. You can have all the skill sets. You can actually have a check for $1 million.
Mm-hmm.
You're around the wrong people. All that goes out the window.
Exactly.
So it's really being selective
it's
exact, who
you're
around.
Exactly.
I'm sorry, we have a caller. Caller from the 848. State your name and where you calling from.
And you're on the Hello. Sexy situation.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
It's early over here. Hello. I'm in El Paso, Texas. This
Aww.
Is some more.
Texas,
I want to give a shout out to a great show. And
that's what's up.
You know, hats up to Mission Entertainment, always showing him some love.
Yeah.
And Flo. Flo, I'm going to need you to get in the camera a little bit. But Flo, my daughter loves you.
Aww.
And she wanted to speak to Flo this evening. Hey, Norm.
What's up, Mama? What's
better?
Good? El Paso, Texas, huh?
Nice.
Texas in the hell.
Yeah, not by choice. Not by choice.
Aww.
I'm really excited.
What's up, Mo? Love you. Much love to you, baby.
Hey, Norm. Hold on. My daughter wants to speak to Flo.
No doubt. Shout out to Keith, too.
Flo.
Hi.
I love your show. You're so awesome. I love how you stand up for what you believe in, and you're so pretty. Okay.
Thank you so much. Thank you. How old are you, honey?
I'm 12.
Okay, thank you, and you know, hopefully you just see the positive sides. I try to bring that out, you know, but also look at the crazy stuff I do as somebody being a strong person mentally and physically, and you know, looking up to someone like me might seem like a bad thing, but it's not, you know. Just believe in, you know, stay believing in yourself, and you'll be all right, and thank you for your support. I love
Aww.
You.
Aww.
Thanks for calling.
Thank you.
Thank you for calling. Thank you.
Thanks for calling.
Bye, honey.
All right, Mo. Love you, Mama.
All right.
Keith, peace out. All right, yo. Shout out to El Paso, Texas.
So cute.
All right, that's what's good. That's what's good.
The fans, you know, they when I tell you, like, they notice, the moms notice, they'll be like, I'll let them watch you, Flo, because you don't do what these other girls do. And I'm so happy. That right there makes me want to cry because that's the type of stuff that makes me go crazy because I have 6-7-year-old girls coming up to me to like the age of 70. And when that happens and a little kid like that realizes
you're gonna make
no, when they realize the positive that I'm doing instead of the negative, it really really makes me happy.
Tissues. Need tissue.
It makes me happy because she's a young girl and what she just said on the show, like the Bad Girls Club, and I love you for that. Because you know what? I'm gonna keep doing what I do, and that's where when I get discouraged, it's that voice mm-hmm. right there that lifts me back up and brings me back and makes me say, Flo, what you're doing, you gotta seize it and you're gonna be okay. You know what I'm saying?
Aww.
So thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And if you listen to what the young lady said, she's grabbing that she's standing. And that's important. Because, you know, this way of the world will push you down.
And it's pushed me down. I'm going to tell you right now, I can speak on that because I have been at the lowest of the low.
Yeah.
Speak about it. To the lowest.
And I will openly talk about everything I've been through from, you know, I'm not going to go there, but from being a young girl and experiencing things that little girl shouldn't, to being an older girl and been in the dark, been in the light. I've been there, but I never gave up. And, you know, I never gave up. And I could have given up 100 times, but I didn't. And do not give up. Mm-hmm. In yourself, do not worry about what anybody thinks about you and believe in yourself to the fullest. Please, people, don't give up on yourself. Forget what everybody else thinks about you. Yeah. They don't matter.
That's where I'm at with it. And again, I thank Shariff, too, for saying that about the struggle, because you know what it is, bro.
Trust me.
Obviously, everybody in here has been through some stuff, you know, because we all, that touched us all. That's why I feel so real and genuine in here, because we've had the struggle, you know? Everybody has their own story, but everybody has a struggle. And just remember, sometimes just open your ear, open your heart, take a hand and, you know, help your neighbor, you know, help thy neighbor, like you guys say. And just do the right thing, you know? Just try to do the right thing while being bad and having a good time at the same time. You got to add that in. But, you know, do the right thing. Do bad things at the same time to make yourself feel good. But do the right thing, you know?
My haters is the reason why I just didn't quit.
Yeah.
I'm telling you right now.
Hello.
Because I felt like if I try to quit, they win.
Exactly.
They win. And by me not quitting, I develop a great team. Our brand grows.
By you not selling your soul as well.
Yeah, exactly. Absolutely.
Not selling your soul to the devil, because, you know, sometimes money doesn't really matter. Sometimes somebody can come to you with an offer and be like, here's 10 million, like Dave Chappelle. He said, come on, guys. I got offered $20 million to do something, and I said no to it. Think about it. Mm-hmm. That's because the devil probably approached it on some, you know, sell your soul. Forget, you know, go against everything you believe in and do this. Sometimes money's not important. And I hope everybody understands that. In this world, money ain't coming with you when you die, sweetheart.
That's
the root of why the three of us, despite the shit we go through on a daily basis, despite the things we go through individually as well as collectively, despite the adversities that we have and the obstacles we have to, like, that's one of the main reasons why the three of us, I'm going to say it, I don't care. There was four of us before, the three of us sit here now before you. Because that loyalty is something that, like I said, we go through our shit. We're not sitting here like we're perfect. Mm-hmm. We're sisters, we're friends. I'm sorry. It took a month for us to be on this show, and it took for you to bring your ass on here and make us cry. But it's all good, because at the end of the day, people always question that. Like, oh, they still together. Yeah, you know why? Because when you have a separate agenda that's so far effing left, you know what? Keep going left. Because at the end of the day, that's not going to break us. Like, people can say what they want the same way how they say, oh, bougie this, bougie, ghetto. Guess what? At the end of the day, our talent surpasses all that shit.
Man.
And our realness, and that's the problem with you. Your realness is going to surpass all that.
That's
going to surpass all that.
I praise you guys for what you're doing. And people need to open your eyes.
It's not even that. We know God gave us a gift. But when we knew that this is what we were supposed to do, was when a fan came up to us and told us one of the first songs that we wrote was The Shore. It stopped them from committing suicide.
I've had that happen too. That's crazy.
That is why we know that regardless of people trying to stop us and come in our path and make us change and do all the things that they try to do, us staying true to who we are is what our true fans, what the true people, what real people. Right. People with big hearts, they can appreciate us, because that's what we're going to give all the time. We give you our all, and nobody's going to stop this. Okay, forgive us for crying.
Nah, but you know what?
Looking at our eyeliner
running. That's the real stuff right there. That's the real stuff.
No real talk, it's your loyalty. It's your loyalty is hard to find, man. It's your loyalty that inspires me, that inspired me to say, I listened to y'all talk and things y'all went through, and just the things I've gotten to learn about y'all, it's y'all loyalty that inspires me, because all my biggest problems has always been with loyalty because they say, Storm, you put so much trust in this person. You put so much, and that's the same person either trying to take what you got, you know, or take you off your path, you know what I'm saying, or hate or stand you in the wrong direction or make up lies about you to try to mess up your business or whatever like that. You can't break me because I've been doing this for a minute. Right. Anybody that know me know I've been in this game for a minute, beyond BKS1 Radio. Right. Mm-hmm. I've been in studios with Whitney Houston, Bobby Brown, all of that. Check the resume. Make some calls.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? I've been around for a minute. So it's like I learned a lot of things, but what I learned most importantly, that if you don't have a loyal team, if you don't have a loyal team, if you don't have the right people around you, because everybody needs a team to make it. And Shariff said that earlier. You know what I'm saying?
Talking about it all day today.
Yeah, you nothing without your team. Yeah, I'm talented.
Right.
I'm talented and all that, and I got skills and all of that. But you got to have a tight and a loyal team around you. Without that team,
let me add on to this, ladies. Just for you two, Flo. And now, what I'm about to say, I always remind myself of this, that there's a promise that God has made.
Shariff.
And he doesn't break his promises. There's a present. There's prosperity in front of you. Listen to me. But sometimes in order to get to that, you learn. If you guys are already doing this, because if you didn't, you wouldn't be. You've learned to play through the pain, through the pressure, through the problems. And once you play through the pain and you play through the pressure and the problems, you reach that next level of prosperity and that present and promise God gave you. So I just want to encourage you, while you go through those struggles and while you go through that pain, while you go through that pressure, and you go through those pits and those valleys, understand that's the process of where you being made at. That's your diamond.
Definitely.
Because diamonds are made in pressure. The steel is made in heat. And sometimes it takes that for the best to come out. That's where your new inspiration is going to come from. That's where your new message and your content. So, absolutely. So you take that and you use it. You flip that. And sometimes they're lemons. Sometimes you ask yourself, why? You know, why, God? Why? Why this? Why that? If you look at the greatest athletes in the world, sometimes they're on the field with a lot of pain. But they're playing through it. And I got to remind myself sometimes when I go through what I go through with you know, just family and balancing a marriage, balancing business and juggling through personalities.
We understand.
Asking the Lord to give me better discernment.
Right.
So I can just pick the right people.
Yes, sir.
Through my process, through my prosperity.
Right.
So I just want to encourage you, ladies. You're beautiful. I'm listening, but I'm learning. And we're feeding off each other's inspiration. Mm-hmm. We're feeding off each other's struggle and pain. Mm-hmm. But trust and believe, it's written already.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of you choosing the right folks, letting the best lessons learned, and do not ignore those lessons. Because those lessons are what got you. I close on this quote.
That's what keeps me alive.
Your past. Your past is important.
Mm-hmm.
But your past is not as nearly as important as how you see your future.
Absolutely.
Because how you see your future, it dictates your behavior for today.
Right.
Absolutely.
And your behavior for today dictates your destiny.
Yes.
So as important as your past is, it's just a reflection.
Amazing.
It ain't got nothing to do with that future.
Right.
Just hold that sight. Stay strategic. Very important. Stay strategic, and that's not a bad thing. That's figuring it out, thinking, sizing opportunities up, knowing what's important to you today. What are those values today? My team been with me 8-9 years.
Absolutely.
Because of core values. No matter what happened, when we at sea and them winds blow and the sharks is going around.
Yeah. A lot of sharks, baby. A lot
deep.
Of sharks.
Yes. I'm telling you, get deep.
Yeah.
And you be deep out there. Sometimes you on a boat by yourself sometimes.
Without a life preserver. Without a life
preserver. Yeah. I've been with
and
my
without
team.
Without a manual.
20 years. 20 years I've been with my team.
Nice.
So understanding the best has been through this. We're not going through nothing that the great hasn't went through.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Everything I've ever wanted to say in a nice way.
Yeah.
In a bad
way. But you know what?
You guys are amazing. Yeah. Trust me.
But you know, honestly, I think that's the power of God. Because honestly, like, that's one of the main reasons why we always say,
when people always say, oh, superstars this, and we constantly always say, no, we're Akisa, LaLisha, and Aaliyah. At the end of the day, we were raised a certain way, and we've never let the industry.
That's right.
We've never, ever, ever. People always, because people have this misconception, that the industry is, right. They have this misconception that the industry is the end all be all. At the end of the day, no matter what happened in our past with our careers, highs, lows, whatever, we always stay true to ourselves. Whether people hated it or loved it.
Right.
Even to this day, oh, why are they still trying? Guess what?
Yep.
Because we have a talent, and whether you like it or not,
it
we can sing and you can't.
It makes
who
a
cares?
Difference.
None of that matters.
If we touch one person, it makes
one
a difference.
One person.
Right.
Because
so
God made this happen. So other than that, what you got to say?
We never considered ourselves superstars. We'll say, look, yeah. We just happen to have a career that naturally God gave us, and
right.
That's how we get paid.
Yep.
Give Flo that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we can't hear it.
Yeah.
They're celebrities, blah, blah. Listen, yes, okay, you might look at us like celebrities, whatever, but what you need to realize is certain of us, like, you know, they're superstars, I'm, you know, a reality star. Certain of us, you know, we live the normal life. We are living the everyday life. And I go to Walmart, yes. Don't ask me, what am I doing at Walmart? What are you doing at Walmart? Shopping. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't forget this. People out there that think that, you know what I'm saying, because you're on TV and all that and everything's perfect, but guess what, sweetheart, I've struggled and I've been through it, and why do you think I'm trying to make a difference? Because I know what I've been through, and if there's anybody out there who could do that, somebody who's been through it, that's how. But don't, we're not, I'm not giving up, they're not giving up, so you don't give up.
Let me say,
if we're not giving
you
up, you can't give up.
Thank y'all for making us have the
okay.
ugly cry.
Real.
Yeah. Hold on, I
didn't even
say
let
us
just tear.
Real quick. This, I don't, like, that little young girl that just came on, like, it's deep.
Mm-hmm.
And let me tell you why. Like, I came to a conclusion, and actually heard this, like, years ago from I can't remember his name. He spoke 7 spiritual laws of success. And when he broke down success, said success is that someone else live because you live.
Mm.
And your ultimate mission is that when you leave, someone takes your story and they say yes to their life. Mm. And that's the ultimate accomplishment.
Because
no one is taking a U-Haul to the gravesite. We ain't seen one yet.
Nope.
You're going right to the dirt when you're out.
Yes. Yep.
So it's really how you inspire you. Yes. Through this
like
process.
She said, she stopped someone from committing suicide. I've had a lot of gay people tell me, you know, because I'm bisexual and I represent them, say that, Flo, because of you,
absolutely,
I didn't commit suicide.
That's
and you know what? To me, that's where I can't give up, because a million people
can't
hate
put a price
me.
On that.
A million people can't hate me. If one person tells me they didn't kill themselves
of
because
course.
Of me, I don't care
and you know,
if nobody likes me. That
you know
person
what?
Saved it. I saved the person's life.
Exactly.
That's all that matters.
I'm glad you said that, Flo. I'm glad Lai said what she said about that situation.
That's deep.
That's the real reason why we do it, because at Big Cast One Radio, since we existed, we touch on so many different topics.
Mm-hmm.
We had suicide topics. We had a priest come in here and expose certain things in Catholicism.
Mm. Wow.
We had major things happen right here at BKS1 Radio. You know, that was groundbreaking things.
Mm.
So for me to stop this because maybe one or two people are hating or trying to take me down, whatever like that, I'm doing a disservice to not just to myself, but to other people as well.
Exactly. Right.
Yes.
Exactly.
And we're going to take this caller. Caller from the 908. State your name where you're calling from. You're on the grown.
Sexy situation.
Crying situation right now.
Yeah, we crying.
Hello, caller from the 908.
Yes.
Hey.
Yes, state your name where you're calling from.
Oh, hey there. My name is Kavon Painter. I'm calling from Oakland, California right now.
Hey, Kavon.
What's up, Kavon? What's good?
I'm calling in. I have no idea what's going on in the show right now, but however, my close friend, Stephen Young, has informed me that this is a number to actually call.
Aww.
So if you could update me on the topic, I'll be glad.
We're just
going to
ask you a question. Let's ask him a question for the topic.
Yeah. AK.
We needed this break.
Okay, even though we went completely diagonal left, horizontal, whatever, the topic, we got emotional.
It is what it is.
But the topic for the evening is for everybody to call in and discuss what your worst dating experience was. What's the one thing that a girl can do during a date that can turn you off?
Or funny.
Or funny, yeah. It doesn't have to be so serious, because God knows me.
Yeah, I don't
want to
cry anymore.
what's the worst thing that a girl can do that that'll turn me off?
Right, like a horrible dating experience that you might have had.
Okay. I'll say this. A girl who's very stuck up, you know, who just thinks she's just all that in
who's
the back
bougie?
Of
the chair. Yeah, that's
who's what? Bougie?
You know, I mean, if you are all... If you are all that in a bag of chips, great. Like, allow me to see that. Allow me to experience that.
Uh-huh.
But don't sit here, you know, knowing that. Don't sit here telling me that. One of the most beautiful things about a woman is that if she is all that in a bag of chips, if she doesn't know it, it's one of the greatest things ever. Because you know, you have a down-to-earth chick who's just absolutely beautiful. So that's one of the most greatest things. But however, if she knows that she is the shit, and excuse me for my language.
Go ahead.
But if she knows that she is that great, then it's kind of a turn off.
Aw, thank you, sweetie.
All right,
thank you for sharing your.
We have a caller from
thanks. The six caller from the 601. State your name when you're calling from. You're on the grown.
Sexy situation.
What's good?
Hello?
Caller from the 601.
Miss what?
Bye-bye.
Hey, caller, you're... Okay, bye.
Bye.
Caller from the 601. Bye. Yes, state your name where you're calling from. Oh,
okay.
Man.
You got scared?
All right. You can't, you can't get crying, you can't get scared when you call in. This is the Grown Sexy Situation Show. Right now, we got like five topics.
Mississippi, call him back. Come on, Mississippi.
I'm sorry. Okay. I'm sorry.
Caller from the 601. State your name where you're calling from. You're on the Grown.
Sexy Situation.
What's good?
Bagger's Club. Bagger's Club.
Bad Girls Club in the building.
That's it?
That's all you wanted to say?
Is this what you sign up for?
I can't. I'm so...
You want to sign up for the Bad Girls Club?
Go to oxygen.com. Go to oxygen.com and sign up to run the rest of your life.
We got a bad connection.
Hey, what part of Mississippi you from?
Wait a minute.
This is Flo right here.
Oh,
we lost.
We lost
bad connection.
That's Sprint.
I'm sorry, you was breaking up.
That must be Verizon.
You gotta get.
All right.
Verizon.
Callers, check this out. Verizon. Steve, put in the chat.
Now where I live.
If there's any chat comments, please read them. I'm also putting
good
the chat.
In my neighborhood,
call
him
right now. 646-233-1302. You're live on BKS1Radio.com. We're talking about a multitude of things tonight. We're talking about bad dates. Maybe I'll send this up. What's the one thing a person could say on a date?
We talking about how come Shariff don't have a church open somewhere and you're not ministering? Because God, yo.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nah. I mean, he's breaking it down too. But I mean, you just go through things in life, and it's funny because I put up a post today, man. Just like you gotta. Sometimes God will take you through some things just so you can have a testimony to help
I
others.
Can't right. cry exactly. anymore. No. Use that to make you stronger.
No, not for nothing. Someone once said, if you're not going through the storm, then you're in the storm or you're coming out of the storm. So it's one of the three.
For me, life has always been like a roller coaster, literally down and then up and then down. It's like, we know,
that's the game.
But that's okay. That's what makes me as strong as I am today, yo. That's the struggle. The struggles built my character. And when people talk to me, they could see that right away. And like, you know, that's what you could see that in some people. You could see the shallowness and the non-depth in some individuals out there, you know, and it's kind of sad.
We're talking about this. What did I post today? On my page.
See.
Can anybody read that?
I can't see it.
Is there anybody with good eyes?
Could you read it?
Which page?
Read it.
Yes, right life, on my storm note.
Life will put many obstacles in your way when you're running a race towards your goals and achieving greatness.
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
you may go
true.
Through sickness, financial problems, the loss of a loved one, self-doubt, haters, but remember with faith, perseverance, persistence, and prayer, you can get to the finish line. Yes. God is only building your story for an amazing testimony so you can help others reach the finish line as well. All right.
Aw, that was nice,
that was
Norm.
Nice.
Dropping some wisdom. That was nice.
That's how I was feeling today.
Aww. And that's funny how the show turned
out. We got to take a quick picture. Flo got to go. Steve,
let's take a quick picture. And you guys, I just want to say thank you, everybody, for calling in. And I love you guys. I love you, Allure. I'm going to be at the parties. Every single one of them. Support
you
guys.
Thank you so much, Mama.
Anything you need support with, I'll be there.
Same
to
you.
Same to you.
Of course. Wait, that's the, what's the name?
Keep rocking and keep knocking. Whether you Louboutin it up or Reebokin, you see the hate that they serving on a platter. So what we gon' have, dessert or disaster?
I never thought I'd be in love like this. When I look at you, my mind goes on a trip. Then you came in and knocked me on my face. Feels like I'm in a race, but I already won first place. I never thought I'd fall for you as hard as I did.
Dance with you.
Tonight, and you know I need you.
Word up. Look out for the cops, though. Cash food. Word up. 2 for 5s over here, baby. Word up. 2 for 5s. Them niggas got garbage down the way. Word up.
Cash food's everything around me. Creamed it.
Yeah. Check this old fly shit out. Word up.
Cash food's everything around me.
Creamed
it. The money.
Here we go. Check this shit.